Welcome to the Echo Arena. This is the 2017 British Championships. You might think that 2016 will be tough to beat. We are still celebrating those 7 incredible Olympic medals from Rio. But remember London? It was all about inspire the next generation. Well, our Olympic heroes have done exactly that, because the next generation is here and they are ready to compete among all of our established stars. So the journey toward Tokyo begins right here, right now. Let's take a look and see what they're up to.
The beam.
It's nerve-wracking.
It's a scary place to compete.
Leaps, spins, cartwheels.
And acrobatic sequences make this a tough piece for any gymnast.
One slip and it's all over.
The vault is fast.
Explosive.
It's over in a flash.
It takes years of training to do the hardest skills.
When you hold your nerve and you stick the landing.
There's no feeling like it.
The parallel bars.
Strength holds, somersaults,
swings and catches.
On top of the bar.
And under the bar.
It's tough.
Your arms take a lot of punishment.
It's a tricky piece of apparatus.
The pommel horse.
It's one of the hardest pieces to master.
It takes hours and hours of training.
Leg swings, loops,
flares, and handstands
are needed for the perfect routine.
There's an expectation for us to be good on this piece.
It's up to us not to crack under the pressure.
The high bar.
Spectacular.
Explosive.
And daring.
You've got to risk everything to conquer the high bar.
Massive wind-ups.
Huge releases.
It is heart-in-your-mouth stuff.
And it can make or break a champion.
The rings.
The strongman's event.
Strength moves. Swinging elements.
Every muscle burns. Your heart pounds.
It's a test of endurance. Nailing your landing on rings is a special feeling.
The uneven bars.
Release and catches.
Split second timing.
Grip changes.
360 degree turns.
Everything needs to be combined for the perfect 45-second routine.
One missed catch.
One slip.
The smallest error could end your chance of a medal.
The floor.
Men's floor is so exciting to watch.
Tumbles, strength holds,
acrobatic elements.
The women's floor is our moment in the spotlight.
The artistry. The dance.
Getting the crowd going.
It's powerful.
But explosive.
Elegant. Dynamic.
The floor.
The floor.
Has it all.
And welcome to the Echo Arena. I am delighted to be here with Beth Tweddle, MBE, and Christian Thomas. Beth, obviously a 3-time world champion and Olympic medalist. Christian, European world Olympic medalist and 2-time Olympic team captain. We want to start with the women, Beth, because yesterday was a thrilling competition. We saw youth, we saw experience, and really that podium was just full of talent.
It was indeed, and it was a great test for them. Obviously, off the back of Rio, some of the new youngsters have jumped up into the senior level, but our Olympians were back out there competing. They weren't necessarily doing the all-around competition, but it was great to just see them back out there. Obviously, Claudia, having done Strictly, we got to see snippets of that in her floor routine, and the crowd absolutely loved it. Rebecca Downie was back out on beam and floor, so there was just so much to watch and so hard to follow.
Absolutely. And in the men's competition, we saw a really interesting mixture of youth and experience. The podium was a very interesting finish. What did you make of it?
I mean, Joe went out there and did an absolutely fantastic job. He seized the opportunity. You could tell he just enjoyed the whole experience getting to compete in a wonderful arena like this at the Echo. And yeah, there's 3 new names on that podium yesterday, and that makes it really interesting, not only for the future and also for selection then going into major championships, but then also for these finals today, because some of the lads are going to obviously want to prove themselves. Some they obviously they've put themselves on the pedestal, so it's about trying to maintain that and keep up with the consistency and the good performances.
Yesterday was the individual all-around competition, so we saw all the scores added together, but today it's a completely fresh start. The Apparatus Finals, everyone wants a shot at a medal today. We'll be watching some exciting routines from both the men and the women. They might be a little bit tired from yesterday, but they're going to give it their best shot, and it's going to be great. In the senior women's all-around competition, Georgia Mae Fenton of East London appeared to be flying high with a world-class performance on bars, attaining a massive 14.9. Although this was the top score of the entire competition, unfortunately, challenges on beam and floor kept Fenton off the all-around medal podium, having to settle for fourth place. Maisie Methuen of Phoenix Gymnastics walked into the venue as the 2016 junior all-around champion and never looked back. Maisie was impressive with strong performances on vault and floor exercise, where she combined well-controlled tumbling and expressive choreography to grab both the audience and the judges' attention. Another gymnast easily making the big leap from junior to senior was Alice Kinsella, who represents Park Rican School of Gymnastics. Kinsella had strong performances on vault and floor exercise. However, it was her daring routine on balance beam, performed with absolute precision, that gave her the edge over the rest of the field, scoring a well-deserved 14.05. The two junior stars certainly made the most of their senior debut, sharing the silver medal position on the podium. But only one gymnast totally dominated the entire competition from start to finish, and that was clearly Ellie Downie of Knott's Gymnastics. She was fiercely focused on new elements and high-level routines, performed with complete confidence, control, and consistency. Her powerful vault put her on the right track, but it was her brand new floor routine that took her to the top of the podium. Exciting, expressive dance combined with Ellie's trademark sky-high tumbling completely captivated the sold-out crowd at the Echo Arena. In the end, Ellie Downie was 2 full points ahead of her competitors, easily taking her rightful place on top of the medal podium as the 2017 Senior Women's All-Around British Champion. Well, our officials are marching into the venue, and it is electric in here. The audience is absolutely excited about this competition. We see the lights flying around the audience. It's fabulous, actually. Beth, we're going to be seeing a lot from the women today. Now, clearly, we'll see the specialists on vault, bars, balance beam, and floor exercise. But I think there is one routine that people would pay money to see, and that is Claudia Fragapane's floor routine.
Yeah, yesterday she performed it for the first time in front of a crowd, and they just reacted to it. They absolutely loved it. It's got little snippets from her Strictly time, and between herself and the coach, they've really thought about how to cut the music, how to fade bits and pieces in and out, how to get the dance moves from all the various styles in there. So I think it's taken a lot of time to put that routine together. And obviously, having had time out to actually perform in Strictly, she's then had to get her fitness back up, ready to compete. Her main aim is the World Championships at the end of this year, hence why she only did 2 pieces of apparatus yesterday.
And on the men's side, we talked that fatigue might be a bit of an issue because they have 6 pieces to do. Some of the gentlemen will be a little busier than others. We saw such powerful routines yesterday. How do you think a young gymnast like Joe Fraser is going to react to today after winning yesterday?
I think he's going to be very excited still. I think he probably didn't get much sleep last night. But that's usual, and that's competitions, and that's usually how it goes. So all this puts him in good stead for the future, because I do think he's got a big future, and I'm excited to see what he does today.
We're all excited. Let's take a look at some replays from yesterday.
The senior men's all-around competition was an epic battle between 4 gymnasts. Sam Oldham from Knott's Gymnastics started on floor with a stylish performance combined with big tumbling lines. Performing with excellence on pommel horse and parallel bars, he started to climb up the rankings, but disaster struck on his signature piece, high bar, and Oldham was forced to accept 4th place. James Hall, representing Pegasus Gymnastics, achieved his top marks on vault and parallel bars, showing good skill level and excellent control throughout. Uncharacteristic errors on floor and high bar frustrated the normally consistent competitor and held him firmly in 2nd place. Dominick Cunningham from the City of Birmingham Gymnastics Club was putting in good, consistent performances. He's known for floor and vault and did not disappoint. His intricate twisting saltos excited the crowd, and he was the only man in the competition to perform the daring Yurchenko triple twist on vault to receive 15.0, the highest score of the competition. Although determined not to fall off the pommel horse, his execution score was severely affected while fighting to stay on. In the end, Dominick Cunningham shared the silver medal with James Hall. Joe Fraser, also representing City of Birmingham Gymnastics, had clearly been inspired by his Olympic heroes as he prepared to make his senior debut. Fraser started off on the right note with an impressive floor routine, full of substance and style. It was clear the night belonged to the young gymnast, who seemed to revel in the atmosphere created by the enthusiastic crowd. His high bar routine contained big daring release elements, and he performed them with the confidence of a veteran. Finishing on pommel horse would be the test of character for any gymnast, but Joe was not to be denied. The 18-year-old will long remember this night as absolutely golden. Joe Fraser is the 2017 senior all-around British champion.
Well, that smile certainly said it all. Joe Fraser, the 2017 senior men's all-around champion. And we talked that this is going to be a big day for him. Now, he's either going to be overwhelmed with excitement or a little bit fatigued. Which way do you think it might go?
He's going to be fatigued. However, I mean, just look at the crowd here today. The energy that's in the arena, it really is wonderful. And they're going to get behind the athletes from the get-go. And there's no reason why, I'm sure, from he can just capitalise on yesterday's success, really. He's looking absolutely fantastic in great shape, so we know he can do it 2 days in a row. So I'm looking forward to seeing him in action today.
And that's exactly what Joe did yesterday, capitalise on this amazing crowd. Now, he's the youth. We've got some very experienced gymnasts that might want a shot at some of those gold medals. Six ups for grabs today, six gold medals. Who do you see as some of the favourites?
Well, I think on the floor exercise, we definitely have a bit of a mixed bag. We know we've got Dominick Cunningham in there, who's won World Cup medals on this apparatus. We also know he's got a great vault as well. On the high bar, we've seen some great release elements, some big skills from Joe, so obviously he's going to want to capitalise on that. And then obviously Lord of the Rings, Courtney Tulloch as well, he will definitely want to defend that rings crown that he's held for the last few years now.
Strength like you've never seen before. We're very excited about watching that. And on the women's side, Beth, I think Ellie Downie will definitely dominate.
Yeah, she will be looking. She's got two very strong vaults, so I would be definitely looking out for her on vault. Bars is going to be an interesting one. Obviously, we saw Georgia May complete a brilliant routine yesterday, scoring the highest score with 14.9. But Rebecca Downie unfortunately had a fall, but is still up there in the final. So it'll be really interesting. She'll want to put that mistake to bed and sort of sort that out for today and hopefully take that title home. Beam is anyone's game. Beam is about who can stay on. At the end of the day, it's 10 centimeters wide. You can see the crowd in here. You can see the pressure that the gymnasts are under. Who can withstand that pressure? Then over on floor, I'm sure everyone would love to see Claudia stood on top of that podium.
Definitely. And balance beam, I think, will be an interesting mix between the experienced gymnasts, but really impressed by Alice Kinsella last night. As a junior stepping up to senior, she literally owned the balance beam last night. Now, can her nerves still hold? She is the European silver medalist, but this is a big crowd in here, and it's at home you want to impress in Britain.
Yeah, totally. I mean, she did so well last night. She was performing pretty much on her own in front of that crowd, knowing that if she stayed on, she had the chance of winning a medal. So I think she knows how to withhold that pressure. Obviously, it's a new year, new routines, so we'll just have to wait and see. But every competition that she's entering, every competition that all of these gymnasts are entering, it's a great stepping stone. Hardly any other countries get this opportunity to perform in front of such an amazing crowd on a podium, and they can use that to their advantage when they're going to Europeans, World Championships.
And as we well know, this is gymnastics, and anything can happen at any time. So that's what makes it so exciting. It's a challenging, demanding sport, and we can't wait to see what's going to happen. Our athletes have marched into the arena now. And our first competitors are preparing. We begin with Masters Floor. This is a very unique concept. We are joining the under-16s, the under-18s, and the seniors. So it doesn't matter what category they were in yesterday. If they were good and had one of the top eight scores, they are in this final. And we are starting on floor with Matthew Boardman representing Notts Gymnastics.
This is a great opportunity for Matthew Boardman, his first time in a Masters final. And you can see exactly why he's in the final, because he starts his first tumbling pass with a 3.5 twist backwards and successfully lands it as well. So excellent start from him. Oh, but he has had a stumble there to the side, and obviously the foot out of the floor lines is also going to be fairly costly as well. But that was the forward tumbling pass as he now moves onto his third tumbling. Very nicely executed, the 2.5 twist backwards immediately into the 1.5 twist forwards. Important now for the gymnast also to use the side diagonals. And that was the round off double back somersault. This is also a great opportunity for himself to show off, show the judges exactly what they're going to be looking out for. Remind the judges who he is and why he's in this final, doing some great flair work there, and then moving into the lift to handstand. The buzzer has gone, so he only has 10 seconds remaining when the buzzer goes. And a triple twist almost to nail for his first time in a Masters final. I should imagine he's going to be very happy with that, competing well above his years there.
Matthew Boardman definitely competing well beyond his years. He represents Notts Gymnastics, and he has a new coach. Sergei Serjanov is now at Notts Gymnastics and making an absolute massive impact. Another opportunity to watch Matthew Boardman. And that's the wonderful thing about a Masters. The under-16s, under-18s, and the senior men all have the opportunity to battle it out for the gold, silver, and bronze medal. Here's a wonderful shot of his triple twist. Final moment of his floor routine, and he made the most of it. And the score for Matthew Boardman, 12.675.
Our next competitor, also from Notts, is Andrew Smith.
Our next competitor is Andrew Smith. He also trains at Notts Gymnastics, but internationally he represents Ireland.
Andrew's well known for his expertise on the floor exercise, competed internationally for Ireland at the Europeans, World Championships, World Cup events, and hopefully can show everyone exactly why. That was the 3.5 twist backwards immediately into the punch floor. Solid start from Andrew there. He's going to be very happy with that tumbling pass. And the second tumbling pass there, just a slight hop forward, but everything was definitely under control, minimizing the deductions from the judges. The double Arabian somersault, so it's important that the gymnasts do show a double somersault in their routine, so they're not able just to complete twists. It has to be the full package of somersaults, twists, the strength elements, as he's holding now, the Japanese handstand. You'll see that's a fairly consistent skill that most of the gymnasts will be performing today on the floor exercise. Another clean tumbling pass by Andrew, and his routine's going very well so far. He needs to make sure now he maintains his focus for these last two tumbling passes. Just about squeezes into the floor there. I think the line judge potentially was debating then whether his foot did step out. Big tumble to finish, the triple twist. Excellent routine there by Andrew Smith. You can see exactly why he's a competitor at the big stage on this event.
Now, the Masters is a completely different type of competition in that invited guests can win a medal today. In the qualification yesterday, guests are not eligible to win British Championship medals. But today, it's like an open competition. And you know that Andrew Smith would love to win a medal today.
You can see exactly there the height that these gymnasts are getting. This is actually a new type of floor that will be used in the World Championships towards the end of the year. So it's a great opportunity for these gymnasts to test it out before they actually get out there, and that will be in Canada this year.
And we've seen a lot of the gymnasts struggling to find the exact timing. It is a great floor area, but it has so much spring, it's taking them a while to figure out how to manipulate takeoffs and landings.
And I think that can always be a bit of an area for the gymnasts when they're not used to a particular floor. But he definitely managed to find his consistency, adjust all the little errors.
And there's Sergei Serjanov. Score now is 14.225 for Andrew, and that puts him in first place. Next competitor, representing the City of Birmingham Gymnastics Club, Joshua Nathan.
Josh there, he's been part of the junior European team that took gold at the European Championships only a year ago. So he has competed on the big stage, but unfortunately on the first tumbling pass, the double Arabian, he has sat down. Important now that he finds his composure and manages to finish the rest of the routine as cleanly as possible. And it doesn't get much better than that. Straight back into the routine, the 2.5 into the 1.5 twist forwards, and is now landing. That was the handspring double twist. Gymnasts must make sure that they provide tumbles forwards, backwards, twists, somersaults, show off their aesthetic quality. And Josh is well known for this as he moves now into his manner position. Most gymnasts can't actually do this skill, so it's very unique to Josh. And you can see that the crowd aren't usually used to seeing that. The crowd respond to seeing skills like that. They really do enjoy it. Again, solidly moving from his one tumbling pass into another. Quick breath to wind up for his final tumbling pass. The triple twist, under-rotated slightly, perhaps a few tired legs out there from previous competitions yesterday, so might be a bit disappointed with that, but it's a great opportunity for him to get to compete on the big stage in front of a packed-out arena.
And he high-fives teammate Joe Fraser. I'm sure he is disappointed. Joshua Nathan was absolutely fabulous in the all-around competition, taking the bronze medal in the under-18 category. But you are correct, Christian. I think fatigue will be a factor today. They certainly left nothing on the floor yesterday. And Joshua is a member of that gold medal European junior team, so he does have the experience. And we saw some fine quality work from him. But the two falls will be very costly indeed. A full point for each one.
And there it is again, the very unique manner. Takes many, many years of practicing strength work just to be able to get into the position and then also to be able to hold it efficiently. And then this was the tumbling pass on his final. Fortunately, did under-rotate it.
And it will have an impact on his score, no doubt. Top score so far is 14.225. But Joshua Nathan, 11.775. Our next competitor, Joe Fraser, the 2017 Senior Men's All-Around Champion.
Joe, very much man of the moment at the minute. All eyes are going to be on him. This is a great opportunity to show the national coaches that he's able to perform consistently over multiple days. And that's exactly how he would have started, the double twist in Dorvac, a new addition into his routine, so I'm sure he'll be very relieved to get that one out of the way. Oh, and sadly there, it's going to be very costly. A major deduction, that would definitely be one mark off straight away. You can definitely see that the gymnasts are going to be struggling today with tiredness, the fact that it's 2 days in a row. Manages to find his feet on the double Arabian tumbling pass. And then we'll move into his pommel work. The triple rush in there from Joe. Quick pause there just to regather his breath. Important that the gymnast hold that handstand position for a full 3 seconds. Any wavering in and out of the position will be deductions. Now moving into his final tumble pass. The triple twist, the big step back. Probably not as good as what he would have wanted, but he has started the competition off. Now he can gain his momentum for the rest of the day and hopefully finish the rest of the day as strong as possible.
Well, the first line was indeed interesting. It almost looked effortless for him on the double twisting, double salto, but the second line, I don't know if it was fatigue or if he was trying so hard to stick it, he was just a little bit low.
And this was his first tumbling pass. The double twisting door back, plenty of height, lots of rotation, spotted the landing very well. Exactly how he would have trained it multiple times in the gym. And this was the error on the second tumbling pass. As you can see, just fell short. You could see the slight disappointment on his face. And moving into the 2.5 backwards, immediately punching into the 1.5 forwards. Very well executed.
Now it was wonderful to see him fighting back. So one mistake, not about to stop him. We're still looking at the leaderboard. Andrew Smith with 14.225. Joe will be taking a full point deduction, so will not be able to catch that score today.
He seems happy enough down there, though, I have to say. He has got plenty of finals today, so I'm sure he's not going to be too worried about it.
He will indeed be a busy man. He starts out today with 12.30. And now, teammate to Joe Fraser, this is Hamish Carter, representing the City of Birmingham Gymnastics.
So another gymnast, coached by Lee Walls from the City of Birmingham. That's three gymnasts in a row now that we've had. Joshua Nathan, Joe Fraser, and now Hamish Carter. Very stylish on the floor exercise, Hamish. And nobody's actually performed that skill so far today in the final. That's the handspring 2.5 twist, very cleanly through. And again, more forward tumbling, but nails the landing, showing the judges that he's not giving away any tenths on these landing deductions. Important now that as he moves into the second half of this routine that he keeps his composure. And again, finding his feet very, very well. This routine is going as planned. And there's the straddle lifter handstand, opting not to do it in the Japanese handstand position, which is a slightly higher tariff because the arms are wider, so it makes it a lot more difficult to get into the handstand position. And that is the round off flip door back. It was important that he does complete a double somersault within his routine to make sure that he ticks the special requirement box. And now he moves into his final tumbling pass. The triple twist, a small hop on landing, and that was a very well executed routine there by Hamish. And you can see that he's definitely happy with that one.
Very well executed indeed. Hamish Carter made his senior debut yesterday, finishing 10th all round. And that's what's exciting about the British Championships. We saw the juniors moving up into seniors quite nicely. 10th in the country when our British men's team is so strong is an impressive finish.
And I think that's what's so important, making that transition from juniors into the senior. And Great Britain have done it so well over the past few years. Had obviously the likes of Max Whitlock moving into the transition period very easily.
And he does it well. Score 13.925. Well, as Hamish comfortably sits in second place on floor currently, we have another British talent waiting in the wings. Jamie Lewis is the under 18 British all-around champion. And this is his effort on floor exercise. Definitely a specialty for him.
So another junior, great opportunity for him to show off his skills, compete with the seniors. And that is why he's in this final. The half twisting, the full twisting double back, sorry, half in, half out. Nails the landing. And then moves from the two and a half into the full twist. Cleanly through, showing off his aesthetic quality in the routine. Very stylish gymnast, Jamie. And this is also what his main speciality is, the pommel horse. So it's important for him to get that into his floor routine. Builds up the difficulty throughout the routine and can add it. Now he moves into his side tumbling pass. Round off double twist, nails another landing. It's also quite important for the gymnast to be able to land with the heels as close together as possible to minimise deductions. Ooh, and that one was a bigger step on the landing. And you can see it almost unsettled him, so he's going to have to quickly settle his nerves because the buzzer has gone for his final tumbling pass. And the triple twist with only a small step on the landing. Other than that one tumbling pass, that was a very good introduction to his competition today.
An excellent introduction, and the smile says it all. I think he's relieved to get through that. The legs are so fatigued at the end of a floor routine, but he held on to that triple twist quite nicely. As the under 18 individual all-around gold medalist, he's using incredible skills like that to make sure that he's preparing for the Junior European Championships. This is his pommel horse work. Why not use it on the floor? He is so good at it.
Absolutely. And as you mentioned, he's already part of the Junior European team that won gold last year, but still another year this year and next year as a junior. So very, very young, but competing amongst the seniors, stamping his mark on the competition and just giving a little nudge to the seniors to say, look out for me.
Look out for him indeed. 13.775. Moves him into a bronze medal position, quite possibly, but we have a very experienced athlete ready to perform, also representing the City of Birmingham Gymnastics Club, Dominick Cunningham.
Now, Dominick, very experienced on this piece of apparatus. He's a World Cup medalist on this apparatus, and that is why the double twisting double straight, given the F value, so a very difficult skill. And then moves into his one and a half punch double twist. Is that a small step of the landing? A slight strapping on the leg, obviously probably maybe from something yesterday. And that was the double twisting double back, plenty of height, plenty of amplitude. Moving very cleanly through this routine. And that was quite a large step on that landing, so that is going to be very costly. However, you can see that the difficulty in this routine is perhaps slightly higher than some of the other gymnasts, so he has got a slight margin over the other gymnasts for difficulty and execution. And you can see that that was a wobble getting up into the handstand position, and the judges will definitely have picked up on that. Moving now into his final two tumbling passes. Oh, and you could see that he didn't get his feet in the correct position, and that enabled him then to punch the floor in the wrong position. And that was the final twist to finish. He did well to finish on his feet on the last tumble, but he's going to be very disappointed with that.
Disappointment indeed. He is known as a tumbling expert.
Absolutely, and you can see the height that he gets on his tumbles. This is the first tumble, double twisting, double straight. A very, very difficult skill, but performs it very cleanly. And then this one is the same skill again, but in the tuck position. And you can see the height that he's getting. This definitely allows him then to spot the floor and try and make the best possible landing and adjustments in the air.
Well, Dominick Cunningham had a definite shot at the gold medal today, but a costly error like that which includes the full point deduction, will not let him step onto the golden spot. The judges are quickly calculating, and they come up with 12.125. That places him in a disappointing sixth position. And now, representing Barry YMCA, Josh Cook.
This is a great opportunity for Josh here. He hasn't necessarily competed at some of the bigger events, the Europeans and the World Championships, so competing in an arena like this, on a podium, definitely going to give him lots of experience. Definitely doesn't seem unsettled so far. It was a very high double Arabian. Spots are landing very cleanly. That was the step out the floor. You could clearly see there when he stepped onto the red. Obviously, the judges are going to be keeping their eye on things like that. And sadly, they are quite heavy on the deductions. But settles himself back down very quickly into his third tumbling pass. Small adjustment on the landing there. But so far, moving through the routine very cleanly. Important that he makes sure that he holds his handstand position. Seems very confident within his ability in this routine, actually. But there was the full twist, and he put his hand down, however. So that obviously is going to be a big, big deduction there. As he moves into his final tumbling pass. The triple twist, a very popular finish by most of the gymnasts, and cleanly done by his last tumble.
But what an opportunity for him just to be here. He's actually taking the place of Frank Baines. Frank qualified first on floor yesterday, but he has pulled out due to a slight injury he sustained on parallel bars.
And that was the double Arabian, his first and his opening tumble. You could see the height that he got. It allowed him to spot the four. And that was the step out the floor. Then you can see the flag went up immediately. We have specific line judges looking for errors like that. And then the ever so important strength position as well. Judging, making sure that there's no wobbles in that position.
Well, we are still looking at that top score of 14.225, belonging to Andrew Smith. Not likely that Josh Cook can match it with that full point deduction for the fall on the full twisting salto. But the opportunity he's had to compete here is absolutely priceless. And he may be a little disappointed with that fall, but most of the lines were extremely well performed. He eagerly waits for his score. And it is 12.0. That places him in seventh position. And you see our winner, Andrew Smith, easily took the gold medal with 14.225. And there you see your medalists. Bronze medal goes to young Jamie Lewis. Silver to Hamish Carter. And Andrew Smith was absolutely untouchable and takes home the gold medal on Masters floor. Well, it has been wonderful seeing our first Apparatus final with the men's masters. And we're going to see a lot of the under 16 and under 18 competing today. Why don't we take a look and see how they did in the all-around competition.
The 2017 Men's All-Around British Champion in the Under-16 category is 15-year-old Jake Jarman from Huntington Olympic Gymnastics. He was the bronze medalist in 2016 and had nothing but gold on his mind this year. He easily led the entire competition from start to finish with six impressive performances, showing phenomenal consistency. The silver medal went to 16-year-old Adam Tobin from Falcons Gymnastics Academy. He executed clean, classy routines, displaying tremendous improvement over his seventh place finish last year. In the end, Tobin was close to Jarman, missing out on the top spot by just 0.25. The bronze medal went to 14-year-old Sam Mustafi from Pegasus Gymnastics. As one of the youngest gymnasts in the competition, Sam put on an impressive show full of confidence, knowing he has only just begun. Mustafi will still be eligible for the same age group in 2018. Looking at the incredible potential and quality work from Jarman, Tobin and Mustafi, the future is very bright indeed. In the men's under 18 category, Joshua Nathan, representing the city of Birmingham, was focused on hitting every piece, and he did exactly that, with solid, consistent routines to take a well-earned bronze medal. But throughout the entire competition, it was clear that this was going to be a repeat battle for the gold medal between under 16 champion Jamie Lewis and silver medalist Danelle Osborne. Only 0.2 separated them last year, and the competition was just as intense this year, moving up into the under 18 category. Jamie Lewis of Woking Gymnastics took the top spot on his specialty pieces, floor and pommel horse. Danelle Osborne, representing the city of Birmingham, had the best scores of the day on vault, parallel bars and high bar. Both gymnasts pushed each other to produce superb performances, but in the end, Danelle Osborne was awarded the silver medal, while Jamie Lewis was crowned the 2017 all-around champion. The standard of the entire men's under 18 competition was truly golden. And so much talent in the men's under 16 and under 18 category. It's absolutely incredible to see how well the young men performed under this pressure.
Absolutely, and the opportunity to compete in arenas like this, it just builds their experience, builds their wealth of knowledge. And I mean, a lot of people talk about the seniors inspiring the juniors to go out there and perform, but however, I also feel that that also works in reverse as well, because the seniors, they get the opportunity to see the juniors, some of the excellent work they're doing. The gymnastics is well beyond their years, and that almost makes the seniors kind of think, hang on a minute, I need to keep on my toes there. And the juniors are doing such a fantastic job at the minute.
And that's what it's all about. The masters category is interesting that way, because the juniors are nipping at their heels. Under 16-year-olds with under 18-year-olds competing against the seniors. Now, our first apparatus started extremely well, and we're looking at Andrew Smith winning that floor routine. He is so far ahead of the rest of the field.
Yeah, you can see his floor routine here, and this is the sort of competition that's going to give him the confidence now to go to the Europeans in only a month's time. That was his first and his opening tumble, the 3.5 twist backwards, immediately into the punch for somersault. You can see the strength and the power in his legs there, slightly overcooked it, but still managed him to find the space on the floor, make his small adjustments that he needed to. That was the all-important double Arabian somersault, ticking the special requirement box to do the somersaults. And as I said, this would be a great run-through for Andrew Smith, because he knows he has the European Championships coming up in the near future in Romania. And this definitely would have helped with his confidence, the opportunity to go into an arena like this, compete in a similar venue, similar crowd. And again, spots the floor ever so well. He's definitely got such great coordination within the air to adjust himself, to find his feet, give the judges nothing to take away on the landings. Into the triple twist, tiny hop backwards, jams the heels together, and that is why he's the Floor Masters champion.
Definitely a champion. Andrew Smith represents Ireland internationally, and the British Championships truly are the envy of every other nation. This setup at Echo Arena with a sold-out crowd of over 6,000 people, the lighting, the cameras, the venue, the equipment, everyone wants to be here. So this is a great start for Andrew Smith to prepare for the European Championships. But now, from floor, we are moving on to men's pommel horse. Now, once again, the men are competing in a masters format. The best of the best are here, whether they are under 16, under 18, or a senior. We see an adjustment to the pommel horse. Those handles can be brought together a little closer or put further apart, depending on the preference for the athlete's size. And we will begin with a student from Loughborough University. Our first competitor is William Trude.
William actually has quite a bit of experience at competing on the big stages, competed at the World University Games, a big, big international event where he's competed there, I think, a couple of times now. So he's very used to these kind of situations and scenarios, competing on the podium. Has a very clean line on the pommel horse, so wish him all the best with this routine. And he starts straight into the one handle work. A very clean circle. Legs a tiny bit apart on that. The judges will have spotted it, but moving cleanly now into his forward travel. Oh, he has caught his leg there. He's fighting to stay on the Shivado. Does well to maintain his momentum. Fights and struggles his way up to the handstand position. It will be costly. However, he did get through the routine very well. First man up, setting the tone for the pommel final.
And getting through pommel horse is exactly what it is all about. He has a heavy workload. He's at the University of Loughborough, majoring in economics. And he certainly knows how to get right down to work here.
And you can see here now, this is where he just caught the leg. Quite a heavy hit on the pommel horse, so that absolutely kills all his momentum. Has to fight to stay on. But indeed, he did manage to do it. And again, into the dismount there, you could see that he's having to use a lot of his strength, as opposed to using the momentum of the circle and of the swing.
And we talk about attitude is everything. That is certainly what you need on pommel horse. To keep that momentum going after an error, he knows he's done a good job. The judges will be taking a look at two components, the D score for difficulty and the E score for execution. Now, we know he will be deducted for bending those legs, but he comes through with a 12.40. Now, our next competitor on pommel horse certainly upholds Britain's strong tradition of excellence on this piece. This is Jamie Lewis, our under 18 all-around champion.
We've seen Jamie only a few moments ago on the floor exercise, and now he's back again on the pommel horse, perhaps more of his speciality apparatus. And you can see why from the start, the shear to the handstand position, jams into the handstand and back down cleanly. And now he starts his one-handle circles, building up the difficulty throughout the routine. A bit of a stutter there, having to fight to stay on. But that is the very difficult Busnari. And as you can see, look at the amplitude of his circles here. It really is quite special to watch him working on the pommel horse. Hopefully, a junior that's going to be able to follow in the footsteps of Max Whitlock, of Lewis Smith, of Daniel Keatings, as such great role models on this apparatus. Having to fight, and that is such a shame. You could see the grit and determination as he was trying to stay on that apparatus. However, it just didn't quite manage it.
And this is a piece he could definitely medal on. Easily comparable to our seniors, Christian, with his content, but clearly the full point deduction will be heartbreaking for Jamie Lewis.
Absolutely, but I think the experience that he does manage to build in competitions like this, that is still crucial to his development of his career. As you can see, he repeats the skill. Obviously a personal decision there, whether to repeat it or to not. And now he moves into the dismount, up into the handstand. It's such a shame that the fall was so late on in the routine, because you can see the twist, the turns, the flare, the amplitude. He had it all, but unfortunately not quite enough today to stay on.
And we like that he repeated the error. If you fall off and can get back up and do it again with excellence, definitely a boost to his confidence and also impresses the audience and the coaching staff.
Absolutely. I mean, it's one of them. He's just fallen off in a competition and he manages to regain himself, regain his confidence to get back on and repeat the skill. So it was obviously just a slight technical error. He was very confident within his capability of performing the routine.
Oh, definitely. His potential is very clear. And again, his eyes are set on the Junior European Championships coming up in 2018.
He really does, Matt. That looks so easy, effortless almost. And this was going into the fall there. You could see he clipped his knee there, just caught his body off balance, and it's so difficult then for the gymnast to regain his balance. And this was a dismiss. Twists and turns his way along the pommel horse. Nice bit of flair at the end as he flicks his arm up.
And the score, 12.90. Not probably what he was hoping for, but puts him in first place currently. And our next competitor comes to us from Australia, Prasanth Selarathria.
Prasanth, definitely no stranger to the international scene. He's a world medalist on this apparatus, a Commonwealth champion on this apparatus. So knows exactly what it takes to perform here on the big stage. Currently studying in England at the minute. You can see the speed of his circle there, doing the triple Russian in between the handles. Very difficult skill. Not many gymnasts are able to do that. And then he moves onto the one handle. And he really is moving through this routine quickly and cleanly, which is just as important. A slight leg bend there as he clipped the handle. But now he's building the difficulty. Important for him to show pommel work on the leather, on the handles, also in the flares and the shear work as well. Now he moves into the dismount. A slight stutter, but cleanly through, and he will be very happy with that routine.
Prasanth is a very experienced international competitor. He has represented Australia at the World Championships, at the Olympic Games. And if you can win the Masters Pommel Horse gold medal in Britain on pommel horse, the world will know his name.
I think you're absolutely spot on there. Everyone knows the names of Lewis Smith, Max Whitlock, Daniel Keatings, all pommel horse specialists. So to be competing in this final is definitely some competition out there within this country.
Now, pommel horse is the only apparatus that Prasanth is competing on, so this will be a very important score for him, his only shot at a medal today. Big smile, clearly delighted with his performance, and why not? He was absolutely excellent.
Always seems to have the smile on his face, Prasanth. A great gymnast to be around on the international scene as well.
He does seem to be well-liked by all of the guys. We've been watching him for years internationally on pommel horse, and the speed with which he can circle, that alone is such an impressive quality to his routine.
Absolutely, and I think it also makes the routine stand out perhaps that little bit more to the judges, which is equally just as important. They remember the name, they remember the routine.
And now we just await the score. Great shot of Luke Falwell, coach at City of Birmingham Gymnastics. And the score of 13.775 easily moves him to the top spot. And speaking of specialists on pommel horse, our next competitor in the under 16 category, Corbin Fellows, is a specialist.
And what a great opportunity this is. An under 16 gymnast competing against some of the world's best pommel workers. And you can see that he's got a great body shape for this apparatus. Into the double Russian on the one handle, showing some of the seniors exactly how it should be done. And this is some very confident work by Corbin. Into the flare work now. See if he can maintain this very difficult routine. And he moves along the pommel horse in the flare position. And now backwards, the Magyar Shivado needs to be able to keep this momentum going. It's an absolute brilliant routine so far. And he's getting into the handstand position. And he manages it. Well done, Corbin. A brilliant, brilliant routine from Corbin there.
He manages very nicely indeed. He is the under 16 champion by more than a full point on pommel horse. Now, pommel horse is the only apparatus he's competed because he's recovering from injury, but he's certainly doing it with excellence.
Absolutely, look at the lines on the pommel horse there. His body straight out flat in front, exactly what the judges want to see. And this was the beautiful flare work that he did for pretty much half of the routine.
And all of this is new for the new code of points, flare work. There's a premium on that. So we see all of our gymnasts moving toward that element.
Definitely, and you can see there on the dismount, it was quite short of handstand. Only a C value dismount rather than the D value. So we'll have a slightly lower start value perhaps on that front.
Now the score he is chasing is 13.775. Clearly, the low-value dismount will affect his D score and slightly the E score for execution. But the rest of the routine was simply magnificent.
He's definitely making the judges contemplate a few little errors, but what an opportunity this man. He's seized his opportunity. He's come out here, delivered the goods in front of a packed-out crowd, packed-out senior crowd as well, so... The seniors is definitely going to have to watch the backs for this young man in the future.
The pommel horse tradition in Great Britain continues quite nicely with Corbin Fellows representing the City of Birmingham gymnastics team, and they are very busy today. They have 5 gymnasts in the apparatus finals, and he really is giving the judges something to think about. And there it is, 13.675. Not quite enough to take over Prasanth's position, but silver medal would do quite nicely. But we have more excellence to come. Our next competitor, member of the 2012 Olympic winning medal team, Sam Oldham.
Sam delivered a very well-executed routine yesterday in the all-around final. We'll definitely be hoping to repeat this today. Oh, the handstand was just a bit short there. Perhaps not quite the start he wanted. Judges will have picked up on that error. Moves now into his one handle work. The Stockleys into the Russian. Very clean done. The legs jammed together. This is the Busnari, and he's off balance there. Such a shame. Now, as we've seen with Jamie, he actually repeated the skill earlier on in the final. Will Sam choose to do the same or perhaps move on? He remounts the pommel horse. Has opted not to repeat the skill. He now moves into the Magyar. Forward travel along the pommel horse and then into the Shvado. The reverse travel. And now into the dismount, a slight leg bend, but cleanly through. Well done, Sam.
Nice to see him fighting for that strong finish. I clearly remember when the British men won that prestigious bronze medal as a team at the Olympic Games in London. He had the biggest roar of all.
Absolutely. And the great thing is now that these gymnasts are getting more opportunities to compete in front of big crowds like this, like today. This was some of Sam's routine. This was the error. You could see that his shoulders and his hands wasn't quite in line. So that makes it even more difficult to be able to come back down on the pommel horse.
Which is such a shame because he was so strong on pommel horse during the all-around competition.
Yeah, and I think he might be slightly disappointed here, but he has got other finals today, so hopefully he can capitalize on them later on.
He finished in the 4th place all-around position yesterday. but would dearly love to take home a medal today. It doesn't look like it will be on pommel horse, but he has more opportunities to come. Score 11.975 places him in fifth position currently. And our next competitor represents Swansea Gymnastics. This is Jack Davies.
Jack competed for Wales at the Commonwealth Games, so has competed with full international experience. And you can see why he's been selected for Wales previously. He's a great worker and specialist on the pommel horse. Moves from the leather onto the two handles there. Oh, he's fighting to stay on. Can he fight it? He does. He shows that grit and determination to stay on the pommel horse, exactly what we like to see. Will be a few errors and a few costly deductions for it, but not as much as an actual one mark fall. Then moves into the tongfei position. And again, into another sideways travel. The Wu packing difficulty into this routine. And there's the triple Russian into the dismount. Well done, Jack. Fought all the way to stay on that routine.
And Jack Davies shows through adversity, attitude is everything. I think Wales will be very pleased with his development in preparation for the upcoming Commonwealth Games.
Absolutely, and I think he's showed here that he not only can compete, but can do it on multiple days. This is his second day in a row being able to compete and cleanly gone through his routine. Okay, maybe he might have wanted a slightly cleaner routine, but it's definitely a tick in the box. This was his side travel, the Wu. Very, very difficult to stay on the pommel horse and skills like that.
Well, the score he is looking to beat belongs to Prasanth, and it is 13.775. What a great opportunity for him. He looks really delighted. And again, if you can win a medal on pommel horse in Great Britain, that is quite a feat. Thumbs up. He is just waiting for that score. Where will it place him? 13.25. It puts him currently in bronze medal position. We still have more gymnasts to perform, but that's a nice spot to be in right now. And now, representing Pegasus, James Hall is currently performing.
And James will be feeling slightly tired from yesterday's competition, but Pommelist is one of his more specialist apparatus, as you can see, moving from the two handles onto the one, now into the Stockleys. Very difficult to stay balanced on the one handle. And again, there's that sideways travel, the Woo element, earlier seen by Jack. And another side travel, and you can see just how difficult it is to stay on the pommel horse on those sideways travels.
And of course, the fall will be costly, a full point. His pride might be more injured. He knows he can do this routine. He is such a consistent gymnast.
And he's opted not to repeat the skill. Moves into the forwards travel, the Magyar and Shivado. And now builds up into the dismount, cleanly into the handstand position, and solidly hits the floor.
And Christian, that must be such a feeling. They just want to go up and start the routine again and do it the way they know they can do it. But gymnastics, one shot, that's all you get. It is a tough sport.
Can see here, and James kind of was fighting from the start, really struggled perhaps to settle into the rhythm of the routine the way that he usually does so well. This was one of his sideways travels, the one that he did successfully, and this is where he came to trouble. Then into the tongfei, shoulders not quite in the positions that they needed to be, and unfortunately then that led to the fall.
And it looks like he dinged his finger slightly, so he might be dealing with a little bit of pain for the second half of that routine.
Yeah, the pommel horse sometimes handles can be quite unforgiving.
Well, James finished in this silver medal position yesterday in the all-around competition, so he's definitely not going home empty-handed. But unlikely to catch the score of 13.775, which is the gold medal position. Jack Davies still comfortably hanging on to that bronze medal with 13.25. And James comes in with 12.675. That puts him in fifth position. But now, a very special young man on pommel horse. He had the opportunity to stand beside Lewis and Max last year on the podium. This is Reese McClellan, a guest in the all-around competition. He represents Ireland.
Reese does do the all-round, but pommel horse definitely specialist apparatus. And this is why the triple Russian on the one handle, very, very difficult skill there. Only a few gymnasts in the world that actually compete that skill. And now back onto the one handle in the Stockley positions. Important that he keeps the rhythm of the routine as smooth as possible. There was a triple Russian in between the handles. Moves into the Magyar skill now and into the Shivado. Very cleanly so far. Another triple Russian. He's going along this pom routine very, very well. He needs a strong finish now. Into the handstand. Well done, Reese. A brilliant routine there.
And he pumps his chest, he pumps the air. Reese knows he has done a fabulous job. And if last year was any indication, he took the bronze medal and it was a wonderful photographic moment of him standing between with Lewis and Max.
And here is that triple Russian, that skill that we first talked about. Only a few gymnasts in the world can do it and compete in. Max Whitlock being one of them. And then repeating it again, but this time in between the handles on the leather. Coached by Luke Carson, a former international gymnast as well.
And Reese is such a young gymnast. He's in the under 18 category and definitely pushing every senior in the country. Two thumbs up. Very confident. Can he beat 13.775? That would move him into the gold medal position. He was fourth all around in the under 18 competition yesterday, and there it is, 14.90. He does indeed have it. He is the British Masters Pommel Horse Champion. And the scoreboard clearly indicates that Reese McClellan had a clear lead, 14.90, complete domination on this apparatus. Persanth comes in at 13.775 in the silver medal, and Corbin, representing the city of Birmingham, 13.675. Wonderful crowd here at the Echo Arena in Liverpool. Another sold out crowd. Well, we've finished two apparatus and you might be wondering where the women are. We start with the two first pieces for the men because they do six. But now everyone has been waiting. Beth Tweddle, this is a moment for the women. We are coming back and starting them on a vault.
We are indeed, and we are only actually going to see six gymnasts performing on the vault. It is so difficult to just get one vault perfected, let alone having two competitive vaults. Most gymnasts will obviously focus on the all-around, which means they only have to perform one vault. As soon as they go into a vault final, they have to have two vaults that are completely different to each other at senior level. So that's why we'll only be seeing six gymnasts performing today.
And it is a very difficult vault. Not only do you have to be strong and powerful, but timing is of the essence. It happens in a split second.
It does, and today is very interesting. It's both for the boys and for the girls. We're trying to replicate, give these gymnasts the experience to go to a World Championships and the European Championships, where for apparatus finals, they don't get a warm-up on the apparatus. They get the big warm-up a couple of hours before, but then they're allowed in the back gym, they're allowed to do their warm-up. All they get is to walk through, put their arm up, and perform. So it is so difficult.
And I find that especially difficult for a vault. There is so much involved in that run. Now, in the warm-up gym, that's great. They can warm up, but it's on concrete. And now they've got to step up on a podium, which changes the timing considerably. How do they adapt to that?
Do you know what? You're asking the wrong person. I think we should be asking Christian this one, since he is the vault specialist. He performed in the Olympic final in London 2012.
Very good point.
So we'll pass over to Christian.
Very good point. But I do always have a little bit of a worry about that. They warm up on concrete, and then you come back and compete here.
It really is difficult sometimes because timing, as you mentioned, is so, so important on the vault. You have to maintain the adrenaline as well, keep on top of your nerves. And it is a very, very different type of run-up running on the vault on the podium as opposed to concrete. It's a lot more bouncy. And obviously that changes everything then.
And now, the women had the junior all-around competition. We have a great opportunity to take a look at them. So let's have a look at this video.
The junior women's competition showed good depth with 37 competitors in contention for the 2017 all-around title. 14-year-old Tasia James from the city of Birmingham had her sights set on gold this year. Vault was a perfect start to use her pure power. Her intricate bar routine has impressive content for a junior with two big release elements and a strong dismount. Although Tasia had an excellent start to her beam routine with a unique double spin, she was out of alignment on her acro connection and was forced to take a full point deduction. But she went on to display complete confidence throughout her floor routine, which opened with an incredible round off 1.5 through to triple twist. With power, precision, and pride, Tasia James is the 2017 Junior Women's All-Around Champion. 13-year-old newcomer Amelie Morgan of Slough Gymnastics is known as an elegant gymnast, but her vault certainly packed a punch with the highest score of the day, 13.90. The choreography of Amelie's floor routine was well suited to her personal style. It was a moment of artistic excellence and earned her the silver all-around medal. The bronze medal went to 14-year-old Jolie Ruckley of Cardiff Olympic. She showed tremendous consistency throughout the entire competition, going from piece to piece without any major errors. Her floor routine was a delightful mix of wonderful dance and well-controlled tumbling. Congratulations to all of our medalists. We look forward to day two, Apparatus Finals, where Tasia James is looking forward to bars most of all.
So much talent on the women's side, and our youngest gymnasts are coming through the system beautifully. Let's take a look at Tasia James, representing the city of Birmingham on bars. A very impressive routine. She said after the all-around competition, this was the apparatus final she was most excited about. Tasia is coached by Jody Keim, and this is a specialty piece for both of them. Coach and gymnast, very proficient on this apparatus.
So you can see here, she's already packing the difficulty in at a junior level. Such consistency in her work. You can just see here, coming towards the end of her routine, she's got the full turn in, which she needs, straight into the dismount. She's already working those connections which are needed at a senior level.
And to get ready for the senior level, you're absolutely right, Beth. It starts at the youngest age group. So now we're watching our gymnasts come in for the next rotation. Now you are going to get to see a lot of action. We are going to be covering women's vault. And remember, they do too. but we're going to flip-flop back and forth between women's vault and men's rings. Now remember, as Beth was clearly pointing out, there is no warm-up. So they've come in from the warm-up gym, which is behind that big black curtain. They're going to march up onto the podium, present to the judges. That's always a nice moment. It gives your nerves a chance to settle. While the women are presenting in front of the judges for vault, our men are presenting in front of the judges for rings. And six women will be performing on the vault, because only six did two different vaults in the qualification, but we'll be watching eight men in the Masters Ring Final. And we begin with women's vault. Begin. Our first gymnast represents Cardiff Central. This is Carlissa Ellion.
So you can see just in the corner there, there's them doing the full twisting suit. As they're running down, you can see a blue screen that has got a number on that board. That tells the judges what type of vault they will be performing. Each vault has its own tariff.
And while Carlissa prepares for her second vault, we move to Masters Rings. Our first competitor represents the city of Manchester. This is Elliot Cooper.
I was very impressed yesterday with Elliot's his set of ring strength. Fairly new on the gymnastics scene, competing at these big competition events. Coach Colin there threw him up into the rings, and there his first rings element, the Zarian 2 Maltese, very, very difficult. And there's the inverted handstand position. And into the top planche, pressing out of it. Now it's important there that it moves into a swinging element. You can see that they didn't quite manage to maintain the swing momentum and struggle to get to the handstand position. The judges are definitely going to have picked up on that. But moves back into the Maltese position. Maltese is a position that he looks very comfortable in. Elliot now able just to gain a bit of composure before he swings into the giants to handstand. A slight wobble there as well. And this low through handstand again. The double took dismount. A small step on landing. Well done, Elliot.
Definitely a big finish. Double twisting, double salto to end. Elliot Cooper seems quite pleased with his performance. And back to vault. Just to let you know that Carlissa Ellion scored 12.75 on her first vault. But we are preparing now for our second competitor. Just a reminder, the women will be performing two completely separate vaults. They must be different, but the scores both count. They are added together and averaged, so no dropping a score. Everything they do today will be evaluated very carefully by the judges. You can see the focus of Shannon Archer. She recently had fabulous success at the Scottish Championships. She is the 2017 all-around women's senior champion. The waiting game is usually the most difficult part of the sport. You want to go, your adrenaline is pumping, but you must wait for the judges. And Shannon Archer gets the green light. She represents the city of Glasgow, and this is her first vault.
Preparing to run down the vault, you can see it's a difficulty of 4.6, and there it is, the straight Yachenko with a full twist, just the small step on the landing.
Coaches are always coaching. Rod Smith giving her some points. But now, up on the rings, Joe Kemlin-Jones.
Joe, part of the under-18 Great Britain setup at the moment, so still competing as a junior, but it's fantastic that he's made his way into the Springs final. Opportunity again to show the seniors. One to look out for the future. Moves from the straddle planche into the iron cross position, perhaps needing to hold it a touch longer. And there's the Yamawaki into the Onison. Beautiful lines from the gymnast Joe on his swinging elements. And the lifter handstand, crucial that he keeps those arms straight. Again, you can see the difference in the routines. Joe has a lot more swinging elements in the routine, so difficulty won't be quite as high. But what he is doing is producing those swinging elements very, very well and very cleanly. Into the dismount, the full twisting double back. Clean routine by Joe.
And very rare to have an under 18-year-old in the strength piece, rings. He's showing tremendous potential for the future. But now, Shannon Archer with her second vault. She scored 13.2 on her first one.
And she's preparing to do it. Obviously, she needs a completely different vault. She uses the Sukahara with the full turn, but doesn't quite get enough rotation and has to put her hands down for it. Just to update you with Carlissa, with her second vault, she did perform a Yuchenko full turn. So she did perform the two vaults.
And another look at Joe Kemlin-Jones. Score is 12.625.
Coming up next on that apparatus,
our next competitor,
Holly Jones from Swansea.
On women's vault, Holly Jones represents Swansea Gymnastics.
And here she goes, she's using the Yachenko entry with the 1.5 twist and just a small step back. A great vault and very difficult to perform with no warm-up. Just chatting with her coach there, Natalie, who is a former international gymnast herself.
And now on rings, Dominick Cunningham, one of the Birmingham boys. Coach Lee Wolves puts him up.
Dom will be looking to rectify his mistake on the floor. And he moves into the Maltese position from a swing. Slightly more difficult than doing it from this version, the kip into Maltese. Perhaps needs to hold that position a tiny bit longer. And that was the Yonason into the Amawaki and then into the straddle planche. Making sure that he holds it for a full 3 seconds. You see the rings there wobbling. That will be a deduction. Moves into the Gazogi. Cleanly through into the dismount. A few bent legs on the landing and a few steps. So a few more extra deductions towards the end of the routine, but cleanly through overall.
Well, 12.85 is the score he'll be looking to beat. That would move him in to the gold medal spot. But now, back to women's vault. Remember, they must do two completely different ones. And this will be Holly Jones' second vault. Her first scored 13.85.
and a powerful run. Using the handspring entry with the tuck shape and just a small step on the landing. The forward vaults are so difficult to land because they're blind landing. Coach is very pleased with that performance.
Dominick Cunningham waiting for his score. Joel Kemlin-Jones currently in second place with 12.625. Top spot, 12.85, belongs to Elliot Cooper.
Each of the vaults have to be different in this competition.
Shaking out those arms out, Christian. This apparatus takes a beating on those arms. It's unbelievably difficult to perform those strength positions on rings. We wait for his score. And so we continue with Phoebe Turner representing the Academy on vault.
Using the Yachenko entry with the full twist and a good clean. You can see that she's landing within the white. If she steps out into the red, that would be a deduction. Liz Kincaid, her coach there, does train at the academy, which is where we know Ruby Harold, who competed in the Rio Olympic Games. So she's trained with some of the best gymnasts in the world and knows how to prepare for these events.
Well, we had a sneak peek at the score for Dominick Cunningham, and big smile moves him into the gold medal spot with 13.025. And now, a wonderful opportunity for Jamie Lewis. Sam Oldham qualified for the ring final with a fantastic routine yesterday, but he has withdrawn due to injury. And this opens the door for Jamie Lewis.
For 13.025 on rings.
In the under 18 category, and he is now in the strongman final.
Well, we've seen him on floor, we've seen him on pommel horse, and now we're about to see him on ring. So it really does just show how good these juniors are, that they're able to make some of these finals, competing against the top seniors as well. Obviously, rings perhaps not his speciality event.
Next on rings, Jamie Lewis from Woking.
And his coach, Simon Elliott, puts him up on the rings. And this will be a big moment. For a young gymnast.
What I like about Jamie's his usual type of skills on the rings is that he has very, very clean lines. And there you can see he's trying a new strength element. I'm not quite too sure if he'll get the Maltese given, but it's a great opportunity for him to be able to try some of these new swinging elements, some of the new strength elements as well. And as you can see, very cleanly moves into the straddle half lever position and then up into the handstand. Very popular straddle lifter handstand. That is the in low to handstand. Important that he minimizes the amount of shaking on top of the rings. And as you can see there, slight bent arms. Into the dismount, the full twist in door back, cleanly through the routine. Well done, Jamie.
Well done indeed. And now waiting for her second vault is Phoebe Turner. She scored 13.75 on her first one.
And here she is, builds the power up into the vault, handspring tuck front with a half turn, just slightly with the chest down at the end, but a very well executed vault, and that should put her up into first position.
Her coach, Liz Kincaid, it's clear that Phoebe Turner has learned a lot training side by side with our hero, Ruby Harold.
She has, and Liz has got a lot of experience. She's been to numerous world championships, Commonwealth Games. She had Imogen Cairns at two Olympic Games. And now, last year, Ruby Harold. Ruby has now moved out to the States and is performing out there. So she's not completely retired from gymnastics, but she's moved into the college system and absolutely loving it.
Absolutely. NCAA is a total party. Every single competition, all the scores are out of 10. The audience is completely engaged, and I know she's loving it. But and the replay for Phoebe.
And there you can see the handspring tuck front with the half turn and not a step on landing. Just the judges will see that shoulders down at the end.
And her score, 13.412. Our next competitor on vault, Megan Bridge.
There we see the Yuchenko full twist. Very well executed. This is one of the most popular vaults that you're going to see performed today. The next competitor will add the extra full twist.
Jamie Lewis, currently in fourth position, scored 12.50, but now it's an opportunity for James Hall.
James, earlier on the pommel final, had an error on there and fell off the apparatus, so hopefully now he'll be able to get his competition back on track. He's going to do that by attempting the swing to Maltese. A slight arch in the back there. So perhaps not quite as straight a line as the judges might want to see. Then moves into a second Maltese position again. Another slight arch, so the judges will be picking up on these small errors. Important now, it performs some swinging elements. As part of the new rules within the on the ring system, you can only perform three strength elements before then performing a swinging element. Holding the handstand position. In low to handstand. Solid in the handstand. Not giving away any minor deductions. And dislow into the handstand position. And now into the dismount. Double twisting door back. Very high, very clean.
Very high, very clean indeed. If he could go higher than 13.025, he'd be in gold medal position. But now, second vault for Megan Bridge.
And here she goes, using the Sukahara full twist in a tuck position. And yet again, another very well executed vault.
Megan competed in the individual all-around senior competition, ranking 20th. She represents Gymnastics.
And here you can see the replay, building up that power, running down the vault run, the half turn on, then the full twist off with the tuck position. A great vault, and the coaches will be really pleased with that.
And score for James Hall does indeed move him into the gold medal spot, 13.15. A very colorful competitor, Mr. Reese Beckford. Domestically, he represents South Essex Gymnastics, but internationally, he represents Jamaica.
Reese Beckford from South Essex.
I think from the choice of colors of the leotard, I think it's quite obvious to the audience that they can see he competes for Jamaica. Matt Jackson there, one of his coaches at South Essex Gymnastics Club, taking him onto the rings and throwing him up. Important that the gymnasts get that grip right at the start so that they're comfortable before they start the actual routine. And that's the Maltese. Held it for the 3 full seconds. Now into the Honmatu Maltese. Perhaps needed to hold it that fraction longer. There's the swinging elements, the Yamawaki into the Yonison and then into the straddle planche. You could see the legs slightly drop there and had to adjust slightly. But cleanly through the routine so far. Needs to keep this level of difficulty through the rest of the routine. In low to handstand. See everything squeezed and locked together there in these swinging elements. Finally into the dismount, the full twist and double straight, almost a stuck landing. Well done, Reese. A great way to start his Masters finals.
Megan second bridge moves into third place. But back to women's vault. We have saved the best for last. Clearly the strongest vaulter in the nation, Ellie Downie.
And you can see the difficulty score is a 5.4. She's going to be using the Yuchenko entry into the double twist. Absolutely fantastic. We know she can perform this. She did it at the World Championships to win us that team bronze in 2015.
Clearly head and shoulders above the rest of the competitive field. And Beth, I don't think it can be done any better than this, can it?
No, that was a great, you can see here, the entry in, legs are locked together throughout the twist. No step on the landing, and takes a moment to present to the judges.
Truly the landing every gymnast dreams of. Rhys Beckford, top of the table right now, 13.375, puts him in gold medal position. While Ellie Downie prepares for her second vault, we move to men's rings and watch our brand new senior all-around champion, Joe Fraser.
Well, from one British senior all-around champion of Ellie to another in Joe Fraser. Lee Walls there throwing him up onto the rings. Coached him there for many, many years at the City of Birmingham Gymnastics Club. And there's Joe choosing the Maltese position there, really having to squeeze and fight to hold it for the full 3 seconds. See the grit and determination in his eyes there. And there's Jonas in the pipe position into the Yamawaki, which was a tuck one, and then the straddle planche. A lovely position there. You could see that the legs didn't really drop, so perhaps forming it slightly better than some of the other gymnasts. Important on these swing elements that they time it to perfection. And there's dislow to handstand, everything locked together, moving into the dismount as he winds up now. The double twist and double back, a rather large step on the landing, but I think overall he's going to be very, very happy with that routine.
A brilliant start for our young senior champion. But our women's all-around champion is also equally impressive with a 15.15 for her first vault.
Now we know Ellie is capable of a brilliant second vault. She's got a 5.2 difficulty, meaning she's going to use the Yuchenko with the half arm, with the straight half off, and just is out of the boundaries, so she will be deducted for that. But the difficulty will ensure that she stays in that top spot.
And fighting so hard, she was so determined to stick it regardless, but I don't think there's any doubt, even with that execution deduction, that she is the gold medalist.
She is. The difficulty speaks for itself. You can see here, as she's going in, the round off in, the half turn, she's already off to the side of the vault and just lands out. We do know Ellie is training a more difficult version of that vault.
And Joe Fraser, 13.575, moves him into the gold medal spot. But British Lord of the Rings is up next. And he is not about to let that gold medal go easily. Courtney Tulloch takes to his specialty piece.
Lord of the Rings indeed, and this is why, from the bottom of the rings to the top, landing into the inverted cross position, a slight wobble in the inverted position, and not only does he do it once, but he can do it twice, but this time into the top planche, and then into the Zarian Maltese. You can see the muscles in the arms there, having to squeeze as tight as possible to hold these strength positions. Courtney, a European and world finalist on the apparatus, so he's no stranger to the international scene. That was the swing to top planche into the Nakayama, holding the crucifix position. And these strength elements, he really does make them look effortless at times. And just because he can, he does another Maltese in the routine, packing the difficulty in. Now it's important to stick the dismount. Only a small hop on the landing on the full twisting double straight. I think coach and gymnast are very happy with that one.
and it is so important that he is showing consistent strength on this piece.
And you can just see here a replay again of Ellie's vault, and it's the second vault, so you can see she's just off to the side, and that's what means that she lands out of the boundaries.
But certainly enough for that gold medal. Courtney Tulloch now waits for his score. He is the first British man to ever qualify for a ring final at a World Championships. He did that in 2014. So he's really opened that door with that historic performance for our British men. And now we see our younger gymnasts trying to emulate his moves and his strength.
Some fantastic performances on all three apparatus in that round.
Courtney handing out the waves. Looks very comfortable with his performance. The score he's looking to beat is 13.575. That belongs to Joe Fraser.
I should imagine he'll be able to move into that position quite comfortably.
And score for Courtney Tulloch, 14.95, easily places him on top of the gold medal podium.
Meanwhile, then, on the big screen, Ellie Downie takes the title on vault with 14.437. The silver medal for Holly Downie.
Now, when we have strength at that level of excellence, Christian, I think it's definitely worth taking one more look at it. A score of 14.95, that's really incredible.
It definitely is, and I think he needs to be able to stamp his mark on this new code early on the international scene. You can see there the inverted handstand position. So, so difficult. And this, so exceptional to be able to do strength elements like this. The landing, two top planche. Literally not a muscle in the body that isn't working for strength elements like this.
He makes it look ridiculously easy, and we know it's not.
Yeah, it's for most gymnasts, it is such a struggle, and he does it just so, so well.
And there you see the scores. Wow, 14.95. A clear winner in Courtney, Joe Fraser. 13.575 takes the silver, and Reese Beckford takes the bronze with 13.375. Absolutely no doubt about the domination of Ellie Downie representing Knott's Gymnastics, 14.437, an easy gold for her. Holly Jones takes the silver, and Phoebe Turner takes the bronze. So there will be no video about Masters? Gareth? Great. Can I have 1 minute, please?
Thank you.
and a very big moment. We are heading to women's uneven bars. And with the roar of the crowd, you know who's just walked in. That's Ellie Downie. Not one, but two. We have the double Downies in the women's bar final. And while our women are getting ready on bars, our masters are entering the gym to prepare for vault. As our men are coming in, you might notice some of them have done a quick change. They compete in longs for rings, but they're in shorts for vault. That's so when they're rotating, they can grab those legs to increase the speed of the rotating saltos. Ah, Becky Downie, she looks ready. Very confident and comfortable, waving to her fans in the crowd. The women will be presenting in front of the judges on bars. And our men are saluting to the judges on vault.
First up, over on the vault for the city of Glasgow is...
We will begin this rotation, which is the fourth, with men's vault. Now, same rules, Christian, as the women. The men will be performing two vaults, and they have to be completely different.
Absolutely, and the vault is definitely one of those lottery apparatus because there's so much that can happen in such a short amount of time. So I'm really looking forward to see what the guys have in offer for us today.
I'm looking forward to, but my favorite vaulter is Christian Thomas, so I'm really disappointed that he's not competing today. But we'll make our way through the competition regardless. And a wonderful opportunity for David Weir. He was 14th all round in the senior competition yesterday, but he's done well on this piece. And he represents the city of Glasgow.
David is going to be opting for the Yuchenko vault approach. Quite a common approach by multiple gymnasts. He's paring down the vault run. Yuchenko into the double twist, but sadly wasn't able to get his feet onto the floor, and he was also out of the line, so it's going to be very, very heavy deduction there.
And I think that has something to do with what Beth and I were talking about, not having a warm-up on the podium. His timing seemed a little bit off, but totally on. And the crowd knows it. This is our Olympic bronze medalist, Amy Tinkler.
So Amy prepares for the bars. This is the only piece of apparatus she has competed this weekend. So she starts the routine with the upstart handstand into the full turn, just a slight leg separation. Shap straight into the catchev, straight down to the low bar, building up her connection values by linking all of these difficult elements. And there's the shap half. She had a bit of trouble with this next element last night. So here it is, the mark love, and she's safely through it today. And she's just got to finish the routine off with her dismount, and there it is, the full twisting double back. And a big smile with it.
Ah, she points to her fans, gives them a kiss and a wave. And it's wonderful she had the opportunity today to repeat that routine because we know she can do it. Well, David Weir is still awaiting the score for his first vault as he contemplates his second.
Definitely would have had to take a few moments there just to build his confidence back up and just to regain exactly what he's got to do, because that landing was quite hefty. So the deductions are going to be very, very heavy as well.
And there it is, 12.75, and he has a second vault to do.
David Weir, though, has to have a different approach on the vault. Does the Katsumatsu. So that is a straight with a full twist. Cleanly landed this time. So a lot better second vault than his first.
And a great moment for Amy Tinkler. Oh, all smiles. That felt a lot better today, going through that gorgeous bar routine.
It did, and it's always nice. It's her first competition back after Rio. So just to get out there performing in front of a crowd again is always great. So obviously she's got the Europeans coming up. She's actually going to be competing at the World Cup down at the O2 Arena in a couple of weeks' time.
And what an opportunity. Her score is 13.925, so she's well on her way. And now on bars, Elise Oates represents Park Regan School of Gymnastics.
So here she begins. She can see her coach Brett just standing underneath her, just to ensure the safety. And there's the ginga. And that is why the coaches are allowed to step in, just to break the fall of the gymnast, should they not catch the bar.
I have to say, Brett was just as impressive as any gymnast I've seen today. Fabulous quick reactions.
And there's the full turn, continues with the routine, straight down into the pack salto, and continues this routine with confidence. The in-bar work, straight back up. Judges will be looking for tight legs, straight arms throughout this routine. No leg of separation. There she is, the forward giant, to ensure she's got the change of grips. And there's the double front, just with a small step forward. What a shame to have that fall so early on. The rest of the routine was performed so cleanly.
It clearly was. Score for David Rear, putting him into first place currently, 12.75. And now, representing the city of Lisbon, Ewan McCatsier.
And also having a great opportunity here to compete at the British Championships, even though he does compete for Ireland. Strong approach down the runway using the Yuchenko approach. The Yuchenko 2.5 twist, excellent height, and a very, very solid landing.
That is a big vault. 2.5. The long walk back down the vault runway gives him time to rest and prepare.
Absolutely, and he's going to need it for his second vault, because that first vault was exceptional. Look at the height that he managed to get. Blocks on top of the vault with straight arms. Spots the floor on a blind landing, so making that extra bit more difficult. And he should be very happy with the way that performed.
Impeccable execution. Elise Oates patiently waits for her score. But Ewan McAteer is now ready for his second vault, scoring 14.325 for his first.
Ewan hoping to replicate his first vault as far as being successful and with the landing. And it's the Kazumatsu with the double twist. Only the minor step on landing. Well done, Ewan. Excellent performance.
And currently in second position, Elise Oates. 11.525. Next on bars, Charlie Fellows represents Park Regan School of Gymnastics.
So Charlie is a very experienced gymnast. She's performed at various international events, and it's great to see her back competing. She had last year where she didn't really do many competitions. There's the Jaeger in the pike position. Gymnasts have to perform a release and catch on the bar as a special requirement. And there's the high to low bar transition. And straight back up to the high bar with the shaft, straight down. This is where they build their connection. And just lost the timing and decides, rather than trying to carry on, has taken a break and can re-chalk back up.
Well, she has that 30-second period where she can take a breath, chalk. She was fabulous yesterday, seventh all round in the individual competition. And now for the second half of her bar routine.
This is all a part of being a competitor, is being able to get back up and finish the routine off. So there's the giant full turn and into the final test, the double straight dismount and a small step on landing.
Charlie Fellows with a strong finish, but with a great start. Ewan McAteer currently in first place with 14.325. And here's a wonderful story. Replacing Courtney Tulloch on vault is 14-year-old Sam Mustafi, the bronze all-around medalist.
And again, opting to do the double twist, a stuck landing. Coach looked very happy with that, training at Pegasus Gymnastics Club.
And that is what we love about the Masters. We have a 14-year-old competing among the senior men. What a great opportunity.
Important now on this walk back that he's able to regain his composure, take a moment, rechalk, regather his thoughts. Has a big second vault coming up as well, equally as important.
So, in the under 16 category, he took the bronze medal, and he's actually young enough to compete in the same category again next year, so his future is very bright. Second vault now for Sam Mustafi.
Always a great opportunity for the crowd to see the up-and-coming juniors. And he has a different approach, the handspring straight front with the half twist, cleanly through the air and a clean landing.
Bar score for Charlie Fellows, 12.65, puts her in second place currently. And now with power, precision, and a very precise bar routine, we are going to be watching Taitis Mattis.
Watch out for this routine. It is jam-packed, full of difficulty, combinations that many of the gymnasts wouldn't even be able to attempt. So here we are, the short, clear shap, straight down into the pack. Very cleanly performed. And there's the short clear shap with a half turn. And the full turn that every gymnast needs to show. Straight into the catch head, straight into the ginga. That is the combination many gymnasts wouldn't do. And there's the forward giant into the double front. And just a couple of steps back at the end. You can see the smile, the relief that all of the connections went to.
And the score for Sam Mustafi, 13.10. Currently in the silver medal position. Beth, definitely with Taisha, not many gymnasts would do those two elements connected, but that was the favorite part of your bar routine. I waited for that every time. Nobody could fly on bars like you. But now on men's vault, Hamish Carter.
So we've seen earlier on the floor exerciser is greater, doing multiple twists. And there's another example, Yuchenko approach with the double twist. And that was very well executed.
Hamish Carter making it look easy, gives a high five to coach Lee Wolves.
Minimal deductions there by Hamish. Very cleanly executed. You can see the block that he gets on the vault. Gets the height, spots the landing, and only a small hop back.
Beautifully executed. Hamish is coming back from a toe injury, so it's great to see him back to full fitness. He actually missed out on the Junior European Championships last year because of the toe injury, and then re-broke it again this year. So great to see him back to full fitness and running well and vaulting well with that toe.
Absolutely, and hopefully he can build on these championships as well and really kickstart his transitioning from a junior into a senior with these sorts of competitions. And that definitely won't have done his confidence any harm whatsoever. A stuck landing. Hamish is going to be very, very pleased with the way he's performed that.
And with confidence as well, Taisha Mattis moves into second place with 13.775 for that impressive bar routine. Do you hear the crowd? You know who's next. This is Ellie Downie.
This really is Ellie's championships. Gold medal last night, gold already on the vault. Let's see what she can do on bars. There's the forward toe on with a half turn. To ensure that she gets the two different grip elements. Shap straight into the big catcher. Then can continue the rest of the routine. There's the full turn. Straight into another release and catch, straight down to the low bar, building up the difficulty by linking all of these elements together. There's the shot with a half turn and just has the final test, the big dismount, and there it is, the double straight. A great routine after such problems with it last night.
A big dismount indeed. You can see the experience our Olympian has. Proud member of that fifth place team in Rio, and now Hamish Carter moves comfortably into third position with 13.975. We mentioned that the city of Birmingham is very busy today. Here is another one of their protégés, Danelle Osborne.
This is the first time we've seen Danelle today. However, he did win the silver medal yesterday in the under 18 British Championships. Yuchenko approach. And I think he was supposed to do a 2.5 there, but I think he didn't quite get the block he wanted and had to change his vault. So very good coordination to be able to still land on his feet.
Tremendous spatial orientation and quick reaction to make that split-second decision in the air. The judges judge what they see. There is no deduction for performing a different vault than they intended, but clearly the value will not be as high as a 2.5 twist. Ellie Downie looking very composed and comfortable. Danelle scores 13.425 for his first vault. This will be his second attempt.
And though his first vault wasn't the vault that he actually wanted to do, he actually performed it very cleanly. And to be honest, to the naked eye, most people probably wouldn't have been able to tell that it wasn't his first choice vault. This time, different approach. The double twist performs this one a lot better. And that was a cleanly through the air and only the small step on landing.
Well, he still followed the rules. Two completely different vaults, just perhaps not the one he intended. But what we did intend is to see that score. Currently in first place for Ellie Downie, very comfortably with 14.60. And now making her comeback career, representing Heathrow Gymnastics Club, Nicole Hibbert.
And Nicole starts her apparatus finals on bars. And here she is, there's the catch-ev, and just makes it a little bit too big and can't quite recatch that. She now has 30 seconds to chalk back up. and remount onto the bars. You can just see the coach will probably step back onto the podium to get her back up.
And they've been together a long time, Vince Waldock and Nicole Hibbert, since she was a very young gymnast.
There she starts the routine again, the toe on, into the catchev, straight back down into the low bar with the pack. There's the shap, straight to the low bar again, using the combinations very well. And the full turn every gymnast has to show. There's the forward giant to get the forward element and the big double front dismount and just a couple of steps on landing.
Well, eighth all around yesterday in the individual competition, but unfortunately that fall will keep her off the podium. But someone that's looking for the podium is Danelle Osborne with a score of 13.425. And he's back, Rhys Beckford, representing South Essex and Jamaica.
Rhys is known as a very powerful gymnast. So vault, he'll try to use that power to his advantage. You can see that little bit of preparation there, that visual preparation that all gymnasts tend to do on the vault. And that's the handspring, 1.5 in the straight position. However, he couldn't quite find his feet. It wasn't quite the contact that he wanted on top of the vault, and unfortunately he did end up having to put his knees down.
He looked determined to stick it, but definitely not enough air time to be able to land it.
Yeah, we have a second look here. Perhaps didn't quite get the lift off the top of the vault that he wanted, and potentially he might have been going for the stick as well, which sometimes does make you a bit confused in the air.
Nicole Hibbert receives some congratulations or consolement from her fellow competitors. As Rhys prepares for his second vault, he knows he has achieved 12.55 for the first one. Salutes the judges, and he's hoping for a better performance.
And that's the visual preparation again. As we mentioned, very unique to each gymnast. And this is quite a unique vault as well. The Yuchenko half on approach. Full twist off, and this time he nails that vault a lot better than his first one, and he seems extremely happy with that.
Very cheeky smile. That's the one he was hoping for. Nicole Hibbert, currently ranked fifth with 12.225. Our next competitor, believe it or not, is competing in her 10th British Senior Championships. This is the one, the only, Rebecca Downie.
And Rebecca is known for her speciality work on bars. She is a double European champion, has been in numerous world finals. So watch out for this routine. Has a very similar start to her sister. The half turn, straight up, big release and catches. There's the first one safely through, the full turn, into the next big release and catch, and just overcooks it slightly.
And this is where you see how tough our gymnasts are. She hits the mat with incredible impact, stands up, walks over, chucks up, and you know she's gonna finish this bar routine.
Of course she is. The thing is with our gymnasts, they have rehearsed various different solutions, so she knows what to do to get back on this bar. Where will she start this exercise from? Some gymnasts will decide to repeat it, whereas I think Rebecca is just going to go for the caster handstand and go straight back down to the low bar. There she goes. So she's done the pack salto. There's the shap.
into the Ginga, which is a new combination for this season, which is great to see. And then finally, the double twist, the full twisting double back. And such frustration for Rebecca. She's worked so hard on this new routine. Didn't quite work last night, but still got a few weeks left before our European Championships.
And Reese Beckford moves into fifth place with 12.55 on vault. And now we welcome Gabriel Hanna to the arena. Gabriel is a student at the Loughborough University.
A very powerful gymnast, Gabriel. You can see him pairing through the vault run-up, and that's the double twist. A small hop on the landing, but the leg was straight throughout the air, and he seems satisfied with that one.
And, well, he should be. He's a very experienced gymnast. There's his coach, George Predescu. He's taken his athletes to the World Student Games before, including Gabriel Hanna.
And we get another chance to see this vault. You can see the height that he manages to get off the vault. Strong arms there to pop off the top of the vault. He spots the landing. Also staying center in the mats, which is crucial to minimize those deductions.
Sky high he was. Probably has something to do with his mechanical engineering degree. But someone who knows exactly what she's going to do next time, even though she sustained a fall this time. Becky Downie scores 14.02, even with the fall. And now, the most intricate bar routine of all, Georgia Mae Fenton.
We saw a brilliant routine from her yesterday. There's the half turn, straight back into the low bar, using the straddle back half combination. Another shap, and the short clear. And another big release and catch straight down to the low bar. These connections are all about timing. The full turn just manages to save it. And building up into the full turn and a perfect landing.
The one gymnasts dream of. She scored 14.9 yesterday, which is the highest score of the entire competition by far. And it looks like she's well on her way to do that once again. But preparing now for his second vault, Gabriel Hanna, after scoring 13.55 for his first.
You could see himself there pumping himself up for this second vault. It's a handspring double front, so it's crucial not only to have the speed, the power, but then also the timing and when to open out for the landing. Two somersaults obviously makes it a lot more difficult to spot the landing. Handy couldn't have done that much better. Excellent vault there by Gary. You can see just how happy he is. Double fist pumps. Well done.
Putting on one heck of a show. We love this celebration. These athletes work so hard, so long, years and years to perform like that. And when you finally nail it, it feels good.
And you can see that he lands smack there in the middle there, exactly where he wanted. Managed to get the height that he needed as well to make the two somersaults open out at the correct time. So many fine details in such a short amount of time.
As Dominick Cunningham prepares to vault, we know that Georgia Mae Fenton is on the opposite side of the arena, waiting for that bar score. It was incredible, wasn't it, Beth?
It was. I mean, that routine has been a year in the making. She first performed it this time last year at the National Championships, and it didn't quite go to plan whatsoever, but she's had a year to consolidate it, and it's great to see that she's been able to perform it back to back last night and tonight, and both with the similar execution.
Gabriel Hanna moves into fourth position. And while we're still waiting for Georgia Mae's bar score, we're going to watch Dominick Cunningham representing the City of Birmingham Gymnastics with his first vault.
He has a big first vault, the triple twist. He won the vault title yesterday from the senior competition. Oh, you could see he didn't quite get the block that he wanted. He had to make those adjustments in the air and only managed to do the 2.5 twist instead. He performed it cleanly, but he definitely was going for the triple twist.
Now, both vaults have to be different. George May still waiting for that score, and what a difference a year makes, Beth. I remember cringing when she hit the mat, missing that bar release last year. Tremendous adversity, and a year later, she's performing it almost effortlessly.
Yeah, and I've seen her training it in the warm-up as well, and it does look consistent, which is great to see, and obviously puts her in good stead ahead of the rest of the competitions for this year.
It really does. Now, back to men's vault. Dominick Cunningham scores 13.875. What will he do for his second vault when his first vault needed a slight alteration in the air?
Well, what's even more impressive, he's had to completely change his second vault now so that he didn't end up finishing the same way on the vault landings. And he's doing a Kazumatsu double twist with the tiny hop and landing, and I'm 99% sure he wouldn't have even warmed that vault up, so extremely impressive.
Clap of the hands, he's rather impressed as well. And there is the score we have been waiting for. Georgia May Fenton, 14.575, puts her in second place. Well, Beth, she was very close to Ellie Downie, but couldn't quite get that spot. Ellie Downie maintains that gold medal with a 14.6. There's Dominic's score, 13.912.
In the bronze medal position, representing Knox with a score of 10.6 is Oliver Kettlebar.
Well, there you have it. Ewan McAteer takes the gold. Sam Mustafi, the 14-year-old, takes the silver medal. And Hamish Carter, the bronze medal. Masters competitions are exciting with a mix of the age group. And uneven bars. No doubt at all, Ellie Downie, 14.6, takes the gold. Georgia May settles for the silver medal this year, and Rebecca Downie rounds it out with the bronze medal. Beth, this was the winning routine, and it was spectacular.
It was full of difficulty. You can see there the amplitude on the release and catches. There's the full turn straight into the piked Katchev and straight linking it to another difficult element, the pack salto, down to the low bar. Great to see Ellie working bars so well. I think she would quite openly say this is not her favoured piece. To see her winning that title ahead of Georgia May Fenton and then obviously her sister in third, but we know her sister had that fall and can obviously up that score by at least a mark.
And I'm sure she will do exactly that. And as we were talking, every competition is a learning opportunity for the next one. And here is a young man who had a great experience today.
Absolutely. You could just see the delight on his face, on his coach's face, nailing both those vaults. And these finals are a great opportunity for him to come out here and to challenge the best in the country domestically.
And you said it right, Christian, the best in the country. They're here. We are halfway through the competition. We still have men, masters, parallel bars, and high bar. Women's balance beam is next, followed by the premier event, women's floor exercise. And we know who you're waiting for. We're waiting for her, too. Claudia has a brand new routine to show us, and we loved it yesterday.
exciting, hasn't it?
Really exciting. Lots more to come this afternoon. Two more rotations, your opportunity to support our gymnastics. But if you want to see some more gymnastics and possibly other disciplines, maybe you're even participating, come back to Liverpool in the summer. We have the championship series taking place. I believe it's the weekend from the 28th to the 30th of July. Back here across the Exhibition Centre and the Echo, Liverpool always play great host to gymnastics.
Absolutely, it's a fantastic series that happens here in Liverpool. So we've put together a little video package for you all. Just a little bit of a teaser, a taster to whet your whistle. Let's check it out.
Well, we're all certainly looking forward to that in July. It was a fantastic event last year. Now, of course, I know that all of you are so keen to get involved today. You've been taking lots of snaps, lots of pictures, lots of videos. We would love to see them. So please share them with us, upload them to social media. Remember to use the hashtag 2017British. And you can tag us as well at BritGymnastics. And maybe you and your tweet could be featured on our lovely tweet wall. And I think we're just going to have a quick look now to see. We've got some fantastic ones there. We've got some movement there on the floor. Some great videos coming up. And of course, our selfie podium. Brilliant. It's great to see all of those up there. So thank you very much. Do keep uploading. We've still got plenty of time to go. And we look forward to seeing all of your tweets up there. Right, John and Lisa, it is back to you. So yes, just two more rotations to go. In this rotation five, you'll be seeing the men's disability masters on floor. We'll be seeing the masters men's competition on parallel bars, and the women will be performing on the beam. So lots to look forward to. We're just assembling our gymnasts, and they'll be back out in the same arena. Looking forward to hearing your support in just a few moments' time. So please do stay with us. Lots of action to come.
Fine look at Barry Bascolli. He's one of our national coaches. responsible for our senior men's team this year. So we are taking a short break right now. Of course, we are ready for anything, but in gymnastics, sometimes changes need to be made. And right now, behind the scenes, one of the gymnasts is coming out of the competition. And we're not sure who or what apparatus, but we're ready for anything. So while we wait to find out who will be in, or more specifically, who will be out of the lineup, we're getting a fabulous shot of the new vaulting table. And Gymnova is very proud of this. In fact, we're very proud of it. There are only two in the entire world. This vaulting table is called the Montreal, and it has been created for the Montreal World Championships. And what's different about it is there are actually springs inserted under the top. So, Christian, I can't even imagine how high you would go on a vaulting table like this if you had had those springs.
Absolutely. I mean, I'd love the opportunity to actually be competing down there today and to get to have a go at the vault. Obviously, vaults, the apparatus that I perhaps more specialise in, but it's an apparatus that I'm definitely one of my favourites. So I enjoy competing it, the adrenaline rush that you get with it. Just so many things that can happen in such a small amount of time, all the little intricate details. It does really make it an apparatus that is very, very difficult to do with that extra level of adrenaline.
Well, I know Beth and I would have loved to see you competing today as well. And Beth, social media is always a very important part of British gymnastics. I don't think anyone does it better. So we're taking a look at the special wall, hashtag 2017 British. And if you want to send your tweets in to Beth or to Christian, we would love to see them.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome in the gymnasts. Starting with the Disability Masters of Floor, representing Jersey Special, James Lang and Alexander Bucknell. From Knox Gymnastics, Oliver Kettleborough. Representing the City of Glasgow, Ramsey Michelin. From Jersey Special, Matthew Kirkland. Representing the City of Lisbon, Salto, Patrick Quinlivan. And from Jersey Special, Aaron Bonner. In the Masters Parallel Bars competition, please welcome from the City of Manchester, Ellie Cooper.
Well, we are back for the 2017 British Championships. Today it is the Apparatus Finals. We are into the fifth rotation, and this will include Masters Parallel Bars and the Senior Women's Balance Beam. Right now our athletes have the opportunity to enter through this incredibly lit tunnel. We see the flames coming up beside them. It is really, truly dramatic. The crowd loves it, and I think it has an inspirational effect on all of our gymnasts. Nothing like feeling like a rock star before you start your competition. Beth, we're going to be starting on balance beam. Is this going to distract them, or is this going to inspire them?
I think it'll inspire them. It's a great opportunity to walk in, take in the atmosphere. For some of them, it will be their first apparatus final today, so it just gives them that moment to walk out, see what the crowds are like, see what the lighting is like, because like we've spoken about earlier, there is no apparatus warm-up. They are walking out, they will present in front of the judges, and then the first gymnast will get ready to go on to the apparatus.
Exactly right. And we see our women lining up in front of the balance beam judges. The men are on the opposite side, lining up in front of the judges for parallel bars. Now, there is apparatus behind the big black curtain. There is a warm-up gym back there, but it is not on podium, and it does feel significantly different. So the atmosphere completely different than what they've warmed up in, but they're ready to give it a go. And starting on balance beam, our first competitor is Lana Chilton.
And that was a great mount, round a flick on, straight into another element. All these gymnasts are on this competition for the first time with the CODA points that has changed since the Rio Olympics. So they're all testing out their new routines and seeing how the judges are going to react to it. And there you can see the jump full turn sideways on. It's a lot more difficult to land an element facing that way rather than lengthways on the beam. There's the change leg into the tuck jump full. Just mistimes it at the end, but manages to save it. There's your full turn. Every gymnast will have to perform a full turn throughout this routine.
And you mentioned the new rules and the judges. The judges have gone through very intensive examinations to make sure they've mastered the new rules. So everyone's working with this completely new rule book, the coaches, the judges, and the gymnasts.
And here's the last element, the 1.5 twist. Every gymnast has to perform that dismount. It is one of their counting 8 elements that the gymnasts have to include.
And Lana Chilton looks absolutely delighted to start first up on balance beam. That's a tough ask, and she handled it beautifully. Moving over to men's parallel bars, our first competitor represents the City of Manchester. This is Elliot Cooper.
We've seen Elliot earlier on today on the rings, competing a successful rings routine. Now his second opportunity to try and go for a medal on the P-bars. That was the under summit there. You could see that he caught with the bent arm, so that's going to be quite deductible, as well as the leg split there on the joint. And that is the McCut, a very difficult skill. Just taking a pause in the handstand position there, into the Healy. Again, having a moment just to regain his composure for competing the double front on the P-bars. Very difficult skill. You could see that he didn't quite catch the bars as cleanly as perhaps he would have liked there. And that was the Diamandoff into the studs. And again, having to make a few minor adjustments and steps here. All going to be adding up, though, with the deductions. Dual point defense, a few steps back.
Well, Elliot Cooper gets it through from mount to dismount with a few minor variations. Back to women's balance beam. Lana Chilton has set the standard, going through a clean routine to achieve 12.725.
I have the score through on a beam for Lana Chilton, 12.725.
Our next competitor represents Tolworth Gymnastics Club. This is Amelia Montague.
There, you will see the gymnasts are starting to use more difficult mounts. We saw it with Lana, and now Amelia has just done the jump to split. Straight away performs an acro series. They have to include this. Oh, and just comes off after the second flick. That won't get her special requirement, so straight away she will be 0.5 down on her score, plus the full mark for the fall. Change leg into the split half. There's the free cartwheel. The double spin, and just mistimes it again and has to remount. So that will be another full mark deducted by the judges. Nice full leg. Full spin with the leg up. Has to regain her composure. And prepares for the dismount. Using the round off into the double twist.
Well, perhaps finding the environment a bit overwhelming. Amelia Montague sustains two falls, and normally a beautiful balance beam worker. Coach Carla Gale will be consoling her and talking positively about the future, I'm sure. But there's Elliot Cooper's score, puts him into first place with 11.80. Preparing now, Jamie Lewis with Coach Simon Elliott. Jamie is our under 18 individual all-around champion, and here he is competing among the seniors in the Masters Parallel Bar Final.
It's crucial from the start that Jamie's able to get the grip on the parallel bars exactly how he wants. You can see all the gymnasts, they have different type of preferences on the way that they apply the chalk on the bars. That was the under somersault. Slight bend of arms on the catch, and that was the very impressive Bavsar. Catching cleanly with straight arms and now moving into the lift to handstand. Important for the gymnast to not only compete skills below the bar, like the giants, but also above the bar. So that was the giant into the tip-held combination there. And then into the heel leg, moving very cleanly through this routine. A slight leg split and a bit short on handstand. And unfortunately then, that then meant he had to let go of the bars early for the dismount. And undercooked the rotation, sadly.
It just seemed like he really rushed into that dismount, which was too bad. It was such a nice routine. And speaking of a little bit of disappointment, 10.45 will not be the score that Amelia was hoping for. But next up, a very experienced competitor. She has a closet full of gold medals from the UK school games and the British teams competition. This is Phoebe Turner representing the Academy.
And there we see the round-off flick mount. Very well executed. Straight into the flick layout. Gymnasts have to show that acro series, and it has to have a somersault included in it. There's the free walkover, straight into the jumps, trying to build up a difficulty value by linking elements. There's the change leg, just mistimes it. will perform the other skill, will get the difficulty for the skill, but won't get the connection for it. And there's the Sison into the W jump to ensure she's got her two jumps as the requirement. That shows how experienced she is. She knows if she didn't link that first one, she has to put two more into the routine. There's the full spin. Now preparing for the final test of the routine. The big dismount. Flick to one, flick to two, into the double tuck, and just a pace back.
And a big dismount it was. Phoebe Turner finishes her beam routine with strength and style. Looking back at Jamie Lewis, he is going to be a very busy man today. Ended up going into five Apparatus finals. A bit overwhelmed by that, he said, but it's a great preparation for junior Europeans, so he's ready for it. His score puts him into first place currently with a 12.1, but we have many gymnasts to come, and this is one. Daniel Lee.
Daniel Lee will hopefully be wanting to try and capitalize on the mistakes by Elliot and Jamie. If he can go through his routine cleanly, then that would move him into the top spot. And he starts the routine with a moi. Just short of Hansen there, perhaps need to hold it a tiny bit longer. But cleanly into the Tanaka, that was the back somersault with the half turn to catch on the biceps there. So pretty tough on the arms, the parallel bars. Slight stutter as well there on the lift to the handstand. And he moves into the dismount very cleanly. Nice tuck together, toes pointed in the air, and a clean landing.
And he gets high five from the next competitor. Liz Kincaid counsels Phoebe Turner over that 12.575. Our next competitor is Maisie Methuen, fifth on beam at the Junior European Championships, so a very experienced athlete. And Beth, I love the new rules where the women are finally getting back to doing real mounts of interest and intricate difficulty.
Yeah, the code of points means that all the values of the mounts have been upgraded, so you're starting to see all these gymnasts using the round off flick entry. Obviously, it is a risk to have that big mount right at the beginning of your routine. If you do make a fall like that, you've then got to compose yourself to continue the rest of the routine. There's the free walk over into the jump. And here's the acro series, the flick into the layout. That is the most common acro series that you will see our gymnasts performing today. The double spin. Gymnast has to put the foot in front to finish it off to get it credited by the judges. And we know Maisie can perform this spin so well. She did it yesterday. And that is a very difficult spin. She also uses it on the floor. There's the Anodi, the half turning flick. Change leg into the C zone to get her two leaps joined together. And here's the final element, the round off into Maisie the double twist.
A great finish for Maisie, just not the start she was hoping for. Daniel Lee is in first place currently with 12.375. But Maisie, I think, will be disappointed with that beam score. She's one of Britain's most successful aspiring junior gymnasts and made the big leap into senior yesterday with ease. But now it's time for William True to show what he's got on parallel bars.
We've seen Will earlier in the pommel final and now in the P-bar final as well. Coach George Podescu there having the important job of making sure that springboard is pulled out. Will started the routine with a Honma swing to handstand, cleanly executed. That was the under somersault with a slight arm bend there. Minimized deductions, ideal to try and catch that move with as straight arms as possible. Now moves into the moi position, very nicely and cleanly executed by Will. Pauses in the handstand position into the heelie. Into the studs. And then into the cleanly executed double pike. A very nice routine by Will. I'm sure he'll be very pleased with the way that one was performed.
Score for Maisie Methuen on beam was 12.025. That comfortably moves her into the bronze medal position, but Holly Jones has got a different plan. She'd love to move into a medal position herself.
They're using the front somersault mount. Very difficult because it's the blind landing straight into the double spin. Just mistimes it.
And we might
and
just
has to continue her routine. The change leg into the full spin.
And we might just mention now that she's got this opportunity, Miss Holly Jones, because Ellie Downie seems to have pulled out of the balance beam competition.
There's the flick into the tuck back. That fulfills the requirement for having the acrobatic series. Has to show a low element on the beam. Gymnasts only have a certain time to complete their routine, so they have to keep the rhythm. There's the straddle jump in a sideways position. A lot more difficult than performing it lengthways. You have to ensure your center of gravity is over the beam. And there's the round off into the double twist to finish her routine off.
Well, a great opportunity for Holly Jones. We did see Ellie Downie sitting with the physio at the end of her last performance. So perhaps something just got tweaked. And this year is all about the European Championships and the World Championships. So she may have decided to opt out of balance beam right now. And someone who is opting in to every opportunity he can get his hands on is young Joe Fraser, our 2017 all-around senior men's champion. And this is his effort on parallel bars.
Well, Joe is known as a bit of a specialist on this apparatus. He needs higher than 13.45 to move into gold medal position. Lee Wall's pulling out the springboard there. Spent quite a few minutes beforehand arranging the P-bars exactly how he wanted them. Some gymnasts like the syrup, some like the sugar water. Each gymnast has their personal preference, but Joe executing these skills beautifully at the moment. Not giving away any deductions. Perhaps needed to hold that single bar element a slight bit longer there. Very difficult skill. And to rethink on his feet there, as a minor error made him have to change his routine slightly. And that was the tip out. Into the dismount, dual pike stuck, and he really is having a great weekend, Joe.
Well, the men's squad talks about every point one counts, every landing is important, and he's certainly mastering that. Oh, Holly Jones moves into fourth place with a 11.3, and now. On balance beam, we get a wonderful look at Megan Bridge.
And we've already seen Megan competing on vault today, so she's coming out for her second piece of apparatus. There's the change leg. Has to ensure she links two leaps together. So even though she had that break after the change leg, she then linked the next two elements together. A great opportunity for Megan to be competing in this arena. There's the free cartwheel into the layout. And it just shows how difficult this piece of apparatus is under all of that pressure. Has to recompose herself to continue with the routine. Gymnasts will have rehearsed this in training. Coaches will have ensured there's the change leg quarter just to come backwards. Coaches will have ensured if they've fallen off in training, they have to get back up and continue routine so that they know exactly what to do in competition.
And Beth, she may have been given very short notice about this performance. Rebecca Downie is supposed to be competing right now, and like the viewers at home, we are waiting to see her, but obviously she has withdrawn from the competition as well. So a great opportunity for Megan, but perhaps with very little warning and very little warm-up in the gym behind the curtain.
Finishing her routine with the free walkover. Showed a great legs, a full spin with the leg up. And then just finally the round off into the one and a half twist to finish that routine off.
So our 2016 senior women's balance beam champion, Rebecca Downie, seems to have withdrawn from the competition. But Megan Bridge has gained some valuable experience competing at the Echo Arena. And now the Birmingham boys are back. This is Danelle Osborne.
Danelle following in the footsteps of Joe Fraser. Trained together at the same club, City of Birmingham. Danelle finished second yesterday in the under-18s all-around final, just behind Jamie Lewis. And that was a very high joint there. Important to show amplitude and momentum throughout this piece of apparatus. And that was the Healy, starting in the handstand position and catched in the back support. Into the diamond off, a slight leg split there. Legs jam packed together this time now for the Stutz. Into the dismount, the double front with the half turn. That's definitely a new addition to the routine, and he went for it today.
And that is a big senior international dismount, so it is so impressive to see an under 18-year-old gymnast performing it. Now, Danelle is going to be chasing his good friend and teammate, Joe Fraser. Joe is currently sitting in first place with 13.625, and Danelle would just love to top that. There is a very healthy rivalry, great friendship among all of these gymnasts, and the five Birmingham boys have been very busy today with Coach Lee Wools and Luke Falwell.
They definitely seem very, very happy with the performance there between the two of them.
And Megan Bridge waits for her score. Just a reminder that Holly Jones scored 10.20. So currently, the score to beat on balance beam to get that gold medal would be 12.725. But Megan Bridge doesn't attain it. She has 10.2. And now, a beautiful beam worker, Natalia Bevan.
Teammate with Maisie and the Welsh team, has performed at various international events.
And Beth, years ago when I first saw her as a young espoir, she melted my soul. She has a feeling for balance beam that most don't have, and Tracy Skirton derives a lot of pleasure from working with her on this apparatus. Most gymnasts fear balance beam, she does not.
She's a very artistic gymnast to watch and very elegant, so keep an eye out throughout this routine for what we can see. She's going to use the jump into splits on the beam. Coach Tracy just removing the springboard to ensure the safety of the gymnast. Beautiful Valdez performed. You can see the change leg into the change leg half. That's showing how flexible a gymnast she is. Here's the next element, the free cartwheel into the layout. And if your hips and shoulders are not in line with that beam, you will be off. And unfortunately, we've seen that many times today. There's the change leg ring.
Well, it's always this environment. Apparatus finals, nowhere to hide. You're out there alone, and 6,000 people are watching you and only you.
But she continues the routine. There's the free walkover into the stag ring. full turn that every gymnast has to perform throughout this routine. All the requirements every gymnast has to fulfill to ensure they get that 2-mark special requirement. There's the 1.5 twist from the round off and finishes her routine off.
Well, today is not her day, but her potential is very clear. And Danelle, you see that big smile? He just knows he beat his good friend and teammate. He takes over the gold medal spot, and Joe just has to grin and bear it. Our next competitor would love to get on to the medal podium on this piece. James Hall represents Pegasus Gymnastics.
And what's quite interesting with the Joe's and Danelle's routine is Joe actually had the slightly higher start value. But Danelle cleanly executed his routine slightly better. Just shows how important execution is in this new code of points. But James now working his way through the P-bar routine. First half going very, very well. Cleanly performing the Tanaka element there. Catching on his upper arms. That was a mistake. They could see the legs. They lost some form and also the back. Trying to regain momentum now with the Healy element. Into the front uprise, and now into the shroud front. Nice and high and cleanly catches that. Very difficult skill. Important now to finish this routine as clean as he can. Next he competes the double front dismount. Only a small step on the landing, so I'm sure he's finished that routine as best as he possibly could.
And I think he'll be feeling good about that. He's gone through some adversity during this competition, and lots of adversity on balance beam today. It has been a challenge. Latalia moves into the second place position with 12.475, but 12.575 is a score to beat, and this is a young lady that certainly can. Alice Kinsella is the silver medalist at the Junior Europeans on this piece, and she is exquisite.
A great start to that routine. The backflip to the hold. See her coach, Christine, just pulling the board out. Alice has performed at the recent World Cup event in Stuttgart. And building up her experience as a senior gymnast. And there we can just see the double spin just coming to falter.
Aaron Bonner finishing on floor with Jersey Special. And happy birthday for tomorrow. Enjoy your 21st celebrations.
Such a difficult situation for these gymnasts. If they make the mistake right at the beginning of the routine, they still know they've got the whole routine to perform. You can see her focusing on the beam, preparing for her next element. Here it is, the free cartwheel into the layout. Performed it so well yesterday and just mistimed that landing today. Here's the free walkover into the W jump split C zone. Got to keep that focus right until the end of the competition, right until the end of this routine. Here she goes for the round off into the 2.5 twist, and just a step over to the side. Not the routine she will have been hoping for, but definitely a learning experience.
Well, a very difficult and intricate routine with impressive difficulty, but today it was a bit overwhelming for her, clearly with 2 falls. But one gentleman that is going to be feeling a lot better is James Hall. He's currently moved into first position with 13.825, but next up, Sam Oldham has an incredible parallel bar routine, and he could top it.
Sam Oldham, he actually qualified first for this event, so I'm sure he'll be wanting to repeat a similar sort of performance as he did yesterday. He does compete so well on this apparatus. You can see why he performs the Tanaka with a kick out, exactly what the judges are looking for, especially on these somersault elements. They want to see the kick out to minimise the deductions. And that was into the McCutt, spending minimal time on the bar, exactly what the judges want to see again. And that was the front uprise into the shredder front. Swinging very cleanly through this routine. Into the Diamandoff. The full turn on the one arm and then into the Stutz, changing direction. And now just the dismount, front uprise into the double front. Oh, and unfortunately he just sits back on what otherwise was a really, really good routine.
It was a very good routine. And the score he was looking to beat was 13.825, which I think he could have exceeded that, but clearly the fall is a full point deduction. And that's especially painful after you've shown excellence all the way through.
So looking up to our big screen, we can have a look at the scores on floor.
Well, Sam was the final competitor, as was Alice. Alice scored 11.425, meaning that Phoebe Turner maintained that top score of 12.575. Still waiting for the score for Sam Oldham. But you can see the frustration. He has worked so hard. He has another opportunity. He'll be competing very soon at the O2. And there's a score, 13.55. He would have easily moved into the lead without the fall, but not today. Well, there you have it. The Masters Parallel Bar champion, James Hall, with 13.825, followed by the young guys on the team, Danelle Osborne and Joe Fraser. Sam Oldham settles for fourth with 13.55. Phoebe Turner led the way from start to finish with solid confidence on the balance beam with 12.575. She is truly golden. Latalia Bevan takes the silver, and Lana Chilton, representing the City of Newcastle Gymnastics Academy, takes the bronze. And Phoebe Turner made a big impact. It's all about attitude, isn't it, Beth? And Phoebe has always had that sheer determination.
She has, and she had a great routine from beginning to end. So here we can just see a repeat of some of that routine that she performed in this apparatus final. There you are, the flick into the flick to two, into the double back somersault. A very difficult dismount to perform, but very well executed from Phoebe, and Coach Liz looked very pleased when she came down from the podium.
Yes, we're moving on to now the winning men's routine on parallel bars. James Hall will be very pleased with this gold medal, won't he, Christian?
Absolutely, he's had a bit of a rough day today with the fall on the pommel horse earlier on, but it's great for him to come out here. Not only did he win a medal yesterday in the all-round, but then also take the parallel bars title, even with a slight break of form halfway through the routine. It shows that he has got the level of difficulty in that routine, even if he does make a small error.
He certainly does. And traditionally, James is known as such a consistent gymnast, but he has upped his difficulty considerably on every piece. We know that the men did a training camp in Doha, Qatar, and that was the main goal, to learn as many new skills as possible. So we see that delicate balance between risk and execution, but they've got to be pushing those big scores now and those big skills now if they're going to be ready for Worlds, leading all the way through to Tokyo.
Yeah, no, he's exactly right. It is the time that they need to be performing these skills, because they need to consolidate them. They need to find that consistency. And testing them in competitions like this is the perfect opportunity to do that. So though it might not have gone perfectly to plan this weekend for some of the gymnasts, it is a learning curve for them and a way for them to step forward to do the skill in the future.
And it's always a question of when do we do that? When do we add the new skills? Because, of course, the British Championships are incredibly important. But this year for the senior women, we have the European Championships and the World Championships. So between Euros and Worlds, this is probably the best time for them to push, isn't it, Beth?
It is. You've also got to make that decision. With it being first competition of the season, are they fully fit? Are they ready to use those new skills? So it might be that during the all-around competition yesterday, they went with the routines that they knew, and then Apparatus Finals was usually the time that I put a new skill out because it wasn't necessarily as important as the all-around. But every gymnast sees it in a different way. Every coach sees it in a different way. But like you say, it's the best time now to try it if they are going to use it at the Europeans. If they aren't going to use it at the Europeans, it's not so important. They've got other trials that they can try it out for the World Championships later in the year.
Yes, and it's a very interesting year in that 2017 is an individual year. So the European Championships is not a team event. And the World Championships is not a team event. So this truly is the time for the gymnasts to get a real feeling of what are they going to do as individuals to make sure they have that commitment to the team in 2018. Because that's when it's all important. The rules for Olympic selection, completely different now. The qualification, if a team were to rank first, second, or third at the 2018 World Championships, they would directly qualify as a country to Tokyo, and it would be delightful to qualify 2 years in advance. But it's a big ask, isn't it, to know 2 years out that we've got the team to qualify for Tokyo 2020.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be quite difficult, and it's going to be very unique as well, the fact that this rule has never actually applied before, so there's going to be a lot of question marks. There's going to be a lot of, okay, do we really push for the 2 years in advance so we've got more time to plan for Olympics, or do we kind of gradually build ourselves up for the year before the Olympics and then build from there? So it's going to be a conversation that we'll have with the national coaches, with the gymnasts, with the personal coaches, the medical staff. There's so many people involved in these big decisions. But ultimately, the big prize is the Tokyo Olympics. So everyone will get excited for it, whatever the way to qualify for it.
And it does seem ridiculous we're talking about Tokyo because Rio literally feels like it was yesterday. And I don't want to forget about the incredible 7 medals that have been won by British Gymnastics, 1 in trampoline, 1 for the incredible Amy Tinkler's floor routine, and 5 for the men's program. So 7 Olympic medals, but now we have to switch it off, and now we have to look forward to Tokyo. So this being the individual year, we want to bring it on for next year, don't we, Beth, as a total team for 2018. Well, you can hear by the roar of the crowd, we are now welcoming our gymnast, and the one and only Claudia Fragapane has walked into the arena. This is the moment that so many people have been waiting for. We mentioned that a lot of us would have bought a ticket to see this one floor routine. I'm sure she'll make it worth our while. So in this, the 6th and final rotation, our masters competition continues on high bar. And you will see high flyers in action over that steel pipe, daring routines. Not for the faint of heart. But we also look forward to seeing the women's premier event. Floor exercise, it's going to be worth waiting for. Now, the 2016 floor champion is not in the competition, so Amy Tinkler can't win it. But we have a lot of other gymnasts to keep you entertained. And that gold medal will certainly go to someone very worthy indeed. And we will also have a new Masters High Bar champion this year, as Niall Wilson is not in the competition. He is doing very well on his rehabilitation program and is almost back to full fitness, but wasn't quite ready for the competition today. Our women have lined up in front of the judges on floor, and our men are on the opposite side of the gymnasium on high bar. Young Jamie Lewis. What an opportunity to prepare for the European Championships. This is how it'll feel. He's in five finals today, and nothing less is expected next year. First competitor, Mr. Jamie Lewis, represents Woking Gymnastics.
Jamie Lewis has had a very long weekend, competing in the all-round yesterday and in five finals today, so this is definitely going to be a tiring routine. However, he starts it off very cleanly with the mark glove. That's his release element. Important to perform a release element on the high bar. And there's the second release element, the straddle catchev. Cleanly through, catching with straight arms as well. And that is the hop full turn over the top of the high bar, called the quast element. Now he changes into the undergrass grip. And squat dislocates into some inverts. Important on high bar, the angles of the twists and the turns. As the deductions further away from the handstand will be greater. Winds up for the dismount, the full twist and double straight. A small step on landing, and what a great way to finish off his weekend here at the 2017 British Championships.
And that smile says it all. High bar is not his favorite piece, and he will be absolutely ecstatic with that routine. And now, on floor exercise, Elise Oates, representing Park Rican School of Gymnastics.
Starting her routine there with the spin. Didn't quite complete it, so won't get the difficulty. There's the double front. Very well performed. Gymnasts now have to show a forward element in their tumbles. They can't just do a free walk over or a side something to get that requirement. Great leaps performed by Elise there. Judges are looking for how the gymnasts interpret their music. There's the split jump full turn. Preparing to go into the next tumble. Using the straight front walkout into the double tuck. Just steps out of the floor area, taking a small deduction. Has to keep the concentration right until the end of the routine, and here it is. The 2.5 twist finishes with the D element. That brings her competition to a close.
And a beautiful one. She is a lovely performer on floor exercise. She was sixth all round yesterday in the individual all round competition, but there we have Jamie Lewis scoring 13.025, currently in first place. But his rival and good friend, Joshua Nathan, is next.
Seen Joshua Nathan earlier in the floor finals, so he's had a very, very long wait before he gets to compete on the high bar. He would have been able to warm up in the back gym, but obviously not on exactly the same type of high bar with the same sort of bounce. So having to make adjustments all the time throughout the routine. And that was the straight catchev, a new addition to his routine, but cleanly through. And now he winds up for another one, but this time the straddle position, stretching his arms, make sure that he holds onto that high bar. There's the stolder, and now changing grip into the undergrasp. Similar to Jamie Lewis, now into the squat inverts. Quite a popular choice by the juniors on high bar. Good way for them to cleanly build the difficulty on this apparatus. And now he winds up for the dismount, using the momentum of the swing, full twisting double straight. Great job there by Joshua.
And a fabulous finish to his 2017 British Championships. He was the bronze medalist all round in under day 18, and he did not disappoint today. .325 is the score to beat on high bar, and we await the score for Elise Oates on floor exercise. And there it is, 12.45, currently in first as our first competitor, but a beautiful start to this exciting final rotation. And now, Emily Thomas.
Starts a routine off cleanly with the straddle jump full. Every gymnast can decide which type of music they use. A lot of gym clubs will bring in choreographers to design the routines, and there we have it, a huge first tumble, the double straight. And now has the time to show off that artistry before heading straight back into the second big tumble, the straight front full into a tuck front. Gymnasts have to perform special requirements, and here's one of them, two jumps linked together. Judges will be looking whether the leaps were in splits. If they're doing turning leaps, were the hips fully round? There's the spin, double spin. On to the third tumble. Using the round off lick, double pike, and a great landing. And that is her 2017 British Championships complete.
Emily Thomas packs a punch with powerful tumbling sky high, performed very, very well. Joshua tops high bar right now, just slightly ahead of Jamie with a 13.1. And now his teammate, Danelle Osborne.
Great to see that the first three people up on this high bar final are all juniors, all under 18s. And Danelle's added in a release element there, the Kovash beautifully executed. And now into his second one, the strike catchev, plenty of height, plenty of amplitude on all of these release elements. And then into the straddle. I think for the future, he definitely has the potential to excel on this piece of apparatus. Just looks so natural and fluent on it. Into the squat invert, jams it out in handstand. So important to be hitting those angles. Into the top turn, building momentum now into the dismount. Full twist and double straight, and he sticks the dismount with only a small hop. A great way to finish off his championships.
Well, clearly showing his potential. Lee Wills will be delighted with that. Emily Thomas waits for her score. The judges have got to be impressed by that tumbling.
Very powerful double straight to open that routine. And the big double pike at the end. Very cleanly executed throughout that whole routine.
We've talked about this as a brand new floor area, the Montreal floor with 2,800 springs under it. And she seems to have mastered the timing of it perfectly. She's a longtime member of the Welsh national squad. And there's her score. 12.75 puts her into first place currently. And our next competitor, Sophie Scott.
Sophie's moved up from the junior ranks, was a very powerful floor and vaulter. So it'll be interesting to see what can she do in this floor final. Opening with the double pike, competing for Leatherhead and Dorking Gymnastics Club. A lot of gymnasts have found this floor very difficult to use. The bounce is very different. The one and a half twist straight into the full twist, building up her connection values, linking two somersaults with twists like that does get you difficulty. The change leg ring into the full turning splits gets her that special requirement. The judges are looking at every single move throughout this routine. Are the legs together in the tumbles? What's the height in the jumps? Are the splits fully up? There was the change leg half. And building up to the last tumble. Using the double tuck and just buckles at the knees. I'm not quite sure if her knees actually touch the floor.
And Sophie Scott, the judges will have to make that decision. She was ninth all round in the individual all around competition, and 12.75 is the score she is chasing. Currently held by Emily Thomas. But high bar score for Danelle Osborne. Can he beat his teammates? He does not. 13.075 just keeps him under Joshua, but ahead of Jamie. Our next competitor would love to push on to that gold medal spot. William Trude represents Loughborough Students.
This is Will's third final of today. Performed very well so far on the pommel and the P-bar. Starts cleanly with this routine with the Markloff. Important to keep that body straight over the top of the bar to minimize the deductions. Then moves into the catchev in the straddle position. Cleanly through, but with slight bent arms, which the judges might have seen. Ooh, and you could see there, he went for the shroud catcher with the half turn. He managed to get the one arm on, but the other one kind of slipped off. And he did well, actually, there, not to land too badly.
Missing the element is one thing, but you're right, Christian, that's often the precarious part, is landing unexpectedly. It's so easy to turn an ankle or to twist a knee. So he's landed safely. He has 30 seconds to chalk up, and George Bredescu will put him back onto the bar.
Important for Will now just to get his confidence back, just to finish off this routine. He won't be repeating the skill by the looks of it. Moves into the squat disler, catching in the undergrass position, and then into the top turn, the stolder, winding up for the dismount, the full twist in double straight, a small hop forward.
Well, the score to chase belongs to Joshua Nathan at 13.1, but with that sustaining the fall, unlikely. But so Sophie Scott moves into the second place position with 12.6. And now, Megan Parker, six in the floor finals at the Junior European Championships, a member of that silver medal team.
And a very elegant gymnast to watch. Starts with the split jump, full turn, cleanly round. No queries there. And let's see what first tumble she has. Uses the triple twist, just a slight step to the side. Now has time to show off that artistry and elegance. Change leg ring into the change leg half. Off lick into the double tuck, just a small hop at the back, but very well executed. Another leap and jump. The gymnasts have to use a combination of acro elements and dance elements. The judges are looking for them, and the top eight elements performed will be used. double leg spin up. And here's the final tumble. The straight front into the straight front full twist.
Megan Parker holds true to form. No wonder she placed sixth in the floor final in all of Europe. William Trude is hoping for a big score, but it is 11.225. Very costly mistake. He knows he can do better than that. And he has, he takes a look at his teammate. Gabriel Hanna is up next and represents the Loughborough students as well.
Gabrielle also choosing to start with the mark lob, but immediately connected into the ginger, so we'll get a combination bonus for that. A great way to try and build the difficulty in the routines. Gabrielle obviously won a medal on vault earlier today, so going to be very happy with his weekend so far. And that into the triple back, a dismount we haven't seen very, very often. Over the last few years, but he looks very happy with it and an excellent routine to finish his championships with.
And the crowd certainly loved it. A triple salto off high bar. We rarely get to see that, even at the World Championships or the Olympic Games. So Gabriel Hanna putting on a great show for everyone at the Echo Arena. First place, 12.975. Can she hold on to that, or will this young lady top that? This is Alice Kinsella.
Alice will be hoping to put Beam behind her and show everyone the style that she can do. There's the lovely double leg spin. And using the round off 1.5 walk out into the 2.5 twist. And straight back down the diagonal with a triple twist. Has cleanly executed both first tumbles. Now doing her leaps and jumps, and you can hear the crowd in the background really getting behind Alice, clapping along to the routine, which is always a boost for the gymnast. Front somersault walk out into the double twist. Just has one final test to finish this British Championships off. What can she do? And here it is, the double pike, and just takes a few steps back, and unfortunately I can just see the white flag has gone up, indicating she did take a step out.
We do see her experience fighting to keep it in. She is the silver medalist at the Junior European Championships on floor exercise. Gabriel Hanna manages 12.825 and is in fourth place. But daredevil, big trickster Dominick Cunningham would love to be standing on the medal podium after this routine.
Well, he's definitely got the potential to do it. We know his routine has got multiple release elements in it. Quite an exciting routine to watch, and he starts with a Zulu min to the turn on the one arm, and he winds up for his first release element. The double front over the bar, but you could see he just overcooked it and got the timing slightly wrong there. His heels were a bit too far over the high bar, which meant that he was traveling away from the high bar. You could see the shake and the head, obviously disappointed with that. So it's important now in these 30 seconds to make sure that he re-chokes up, decides what his next move is on the high bar, and executes it as cleanly as possible. The castaway back into handstand, continuing with the rest of his routine. That is the squat into the half position.
and then winds up for his second release. The straight catch of, beautifully caught there. Toes pointed, legs straight. And now same again, but this time with the half turn in the straddle position, the Mojnik, named after the Croatian gymnast. And this time the squat full element, fighting to stay over the bar. Had to change directions then, that will be a deduction. And into his final release element. It really is a shame that he missed that first element because this routine is looking really, really nice now. There's a hop full turn, the quest as he winds up now, builds momentum into his dismount. The full twisting double straight, a large hop forward that's going to be quite a costly deduction also on the dismount.
Well, so much potential, so much talent, but not packaged together today, which leaves Joshua Nathan still in first place. But there's Alice Kinstella with a score of 12.85. That puts her in silver medal contention. And now, Maisie Methuen representing Phoenix Gymnastics.
Using the double squat spin that we saw her use on the balance beam. So difficult to do. And here, using the full twisting double back, just a small hop at the end. The Welsh team do have a lot of input from the choreographer. And here's the double pike and the great landing. Performing the leaps directly into the judges, showing off her artistry now.
Wonderful when we see their personality come through. I'd like to see them enjoy the performance, and Maisie certainly is.
And here, the handspring into the double twist. Straddle jump full, cleanly finished.
And the smile definitely says it all. Will that challenge Megan Parker's 12.975? Megan currently holds that gold medal spot. But Maisie Methuen, beautiful competition, beautiful competitor. Dominick Cunningham settles for the sixth place on high bar. And we have said that the British Championships is the envy of all nations, and here is one gymnast very pleased to be here. He represents Mexico, currently visiting the city of Birmingham Gymnastics to increase his level of working with Coach Lee Wolves.
As you could see there, he really went for it on the first skill, put as much effort into it as he possibly could in the Coleman release. So that was a somersault over the bar with the full twist. But you could see, I don't think he was expecting in the air the bar to be as close as it actually was. Having to make those adjustments in split seconds, and he just wasn't able to make that adjustment and successfully hold on to the high bar.
Well, he has actually moved here for a few months to increase his level, and nothing like the British Championships to try out your new skills, but as you said, Chris, that certainly did not go according to plan.
But he gets straight back into the flow of it there with a huge catch of in the straight position, and then the straddle half as well, the Mojnik release. And now he goes for the squat full. Very nicely executed there. Into the Marklov for his final release. Oh, maybe not. He's got another one in the bag as well. And now changing direction on the high bar into the endo and the heely turn at the end of the endo. The top turn now, going to be winding up for the dismount very soon. There's the quest element, using the momentum of the swing to build into the dismount. The double twisting, double straight,
just a minor step on the landing, and it really is a shame for that fall at the start of the routine, because the rest of it went really, really well for Kevin.
Well, we have to have complete respect and admiration for the way they fall and get back up, and someone who just got on top of the medal podium for floor exercise is Maisie Methuen with that 13.425. And just to let you know, Charlie Fellows is replacing Ellie Downie, who has withdrawn from floor exercise.
Here's Charlie's first tumble, one and a half walk out all the way through to the double tuck. Straight into the change leg half. A great start to this routine. Building up a difficulty now, going down to the second tumble using the double Arabian. And using those leaps, making sure she gets the feet all the way around, and the splits are at 180. There's the split jump full turn. Just has the final tumble to complete this routine using the double pike, and a great landing to finish this competition.
Charlie Fellows puts on a great show. The score she is chasing is 13.425, currently held by Maisie Methuen.
For Kevin Gastella with a score of 12.375.
But Joshua Nathan is safely still in first place, as Kevin Gastelum, he scores 12.375. So no medal for him today. And now, Joe Fraser, our senior all-around champion and high flyer on the high bar.
Joe successfully catching his first release, winds up into the big second release. Excellent work there. That is the Cassini. He's now going to repeat it in the tuck position. Very difficult routine, and that was beautifully done. That was the Coleman there. And now into the Zulie Mint, the one-arm Healy turn. Into the squat dislow, pops it out in handstand. And now into the Stolder, really working through this high bar well. Just the landing now on the dismount. The double twist and double straight, a small step on landing. What a way to finish off his championships. Well done on such a great weekend, Mr. Joe Fraser.
And just to prove that yesterday's individual all-around title was no fluke, that bar routine certainly underlines that point. So well done to see all of our young gymnasts putting on a great show. But our next competitor is the one that everyone has been waiting for. So as we enjoy the celebrations for Joe Fraser, Charlie Fellow waits for her score, and the one and only Claudia Fragapane is about to step onto the floor.
And we have got some Strictly friends of hers in the audience as well. Strictly champion Ore is up in the stands watching her, along with some of the other Strictly dancers. I can see them all getting their phones out, ready to video this routine. So it's really nice to see that they're continuing to support each other, even though they've moved away from the actual Strictly competition.
Well, the score that Joe Fraser needs to beat is a 13.10, and he's sure to do that. Charlie Fellows delighted to move into the silver medal position with 13.05, but you can hear the crowd, and this is a Strictly sensational moment.
And
see how many of her steps you can recognise from her Strictly routines. Here's the big, powerful opening tumble, the double straight. And what a great way to start this routine.
Beth, I wonder if she finds it easier to do here or in high heels.
Straight back down the diagonal using the double tuck Arabian and a great landing. I was talking to a coach last night and they said they'd had so much fun putting this routine together, working out which were her favourite bits from the actual Strictly experience to get involved in.
I bet they did. She grew as a performer, as a dancer, and has such expression and exquisite movement now. It was a fabulous opportunity for her.
And here she goes again. Back down, the powerful tumbling that she's known for. Triple twist, just slightly over-rotated and steps out of the floor. You can see the white flag going up. One of only gymnasts to use four tumbles, most of them have opted just to use the three. And here she goes for a fourth and final tumble, the double pike, and just a step forward and a big smile to finish her championship.
Claudia Fragapane. The crowd loves her. It almost doesn't matter what the score is. She has already been crowned the favorite. She'd love the gold medal, but if it was up to the audience, she'd have it already.
She would, and it's great to see her back out competing. I know she had discussed with a coach, should she or shouldn't she compete here? She's got the World Championships later in the year, so it was just a big debate.
And gold medal! Masters High Bar champion goes to Joe Fraser, representing the city of Birmingham, with 13.875, but this is the moment, Beth.
Here she's using the double straight. We've known Claudia to have these big, powerful tumbles from such a young age. And she goes straight back down the diagonal using the half turn into the double front, known as the double Arabian, and just a small step.
And look at that facial expression. She really has the total package now.
Just that step out, but that was the only major deduction throughout that routine. So it'll be interesting to see what the score is once she comes out at the end. And here's the big final tumble, the double pike somersault. Just the small step forward.
She's making it look easy.
And there she is, just waiting for her score. As she was walking up to the floor, she looked up to her Strictly friends and gave them a big wave. There she is with her coaches, Helen.
Helen Potter is so proud of everything that she's been doing. And I know Claudia's nickname is Frags, but I think it should be Strictly Fabulous now. I think she needs to move on and take her new status. It's wonderful to see her whole experience coming together in the gymnasium. It took her out of training for quite a while, but it certainly has given her back so much that she'll take full advantage of heading into the European Championships and the World Championships.
She looks quite nervous waiting for this score. I think it does mean a lot to her to sort of showcase what she has learned and that personality and that character, and to show people she is back, she is ready to compete.
It is nice to be the British champion. The score she's chasing is 14.425. Excuse me, 13.425. And she knew something that the rest of us were hoping would not happen. So she scores 13.15. That out of bounds, very costly indeed. The crowd has given her the gold medal, but the judges are giving it to Maisie Methuen with a score of 13.425.
Ladies and gentlemen, get ready. We're setting the mood for our medal ceremony.
Taking it with class, as we knew she would. And what a finish to high bar. The boys from Birmingham take a bow, Coach Lee Wools. Gold, silver, and bronze. Fraser, Nathan and Osborne top the podium every spot. in the women's floor final, Maisie Methuen holds off Claudia Fragapane and hangs on to the gold medal with 13.425. Claudia takes the silver and Charlie Fellows the bronze. Well, on behalf of Beth Tweddle, MBE, and Christian Thomas, I'm Carol Angela Orchard, and we hand you over now to the arena announcers for the conclusion of the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it, the conclusion of the 2017 Gymnastics British Championships. What a fantastic weekend it's been. Not quite over yet. We've still got our medal ceremonies to come to celebrate our gymnastics and all the gymnasts and all their fantastic achievements. But before we get to that, got some special guests. I believe Frankie's down there with them. Frankie, where are you?
Hi, John. Yes, I'm down here on the podium, just next to the floor, where, of course, we just saw our amazing performances. And we've got another amazing performance lined up for you from the Dynamite Firecrackers. Now, we saw a performance from these guys earlier today. It was fantastic. It's really, really very entertaining, and in fact they did win the Entertainment Award from the British Gym for Life Challenge last year here in the Echo Arena at the British Championships in last July. So I won't keep you waiting, you're in for a real treat. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the Dynamite Firecrackers!
If you threaten his family, he will retaliate.
fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, another big round of applause for the Dynamite Firecrackers. Oh, fantastic. Gives me shivers just watching that. Brilliant. It's been a fantastic day all round. I hope you've enjoyed it. Do stay in your seats. The medal ceremony is coming right up. I've had an amazing day, and I hope you have too.